evening and welcome to Senior Night. It's week 8 in high school football. The sun has popped out or settled in for a good one tonight in the CBC Kenton Trail Division. Big Lou is here, Jason as well. So peakofohiotv.com is the place to watch this game live for free with the video stream as always. We're on 107.3 The Drive, your home of the Bellefontaine Chiefs football home and away. And it's already been a glorious Friday. The Cleveland Guardians, I'm trying to get used to that name, they won this afternoon over Tampa Bay in the playoffs 2-1. With Don Hensley, I'm Bill Tipple. We welcome you inside to Bellefontaine High School's AccuSports Stadium for a big one in the CBC Kenton Trail between Bellefontaine and Jonathan Alder in high school football as the Pioneers are 5-2. The Chiefs are 6-1, and the Chiefs coming off a record-setting win last week at Springfield Shawnee. 53-32 was the final. It wasn't even that close, and Tavian St. Clair and company had a night to remember, Don.
Yeah, it was an incredible night with 7 touchdowns and over 400 yards. But I'll tell you right now that the biggest thing Coach Brown's worried about is his team thinking too much about what happened last week and not enough about this week. Jonathan Alder has been a tough test for the Chiefs over the last few years. Bellefontaine won the first two games when they joined the league, and then since then it's been all Jonathan Alder, including 42-7 last year. So it's going to be a tough test for Bellefontaine to see if they've matured enough as a team to be able to put last week in the rearview mirror and get ready this week for a tough Jonathan Alder team. And like you said, it's senior night, which I think is a much more emotional night for the players than even like homecoming and some of the other things we sit through, because you know, this is the last game for some seniors, although I think Bellefontaine will play again on this field probably in week 11. But, there's a lot of things to try to get through this week in order to be competitive and to win a tough game against Jonathan Alder.
We will pause and get a chance to listen in and watch the national anthem from Bellefontaine High School Marching Band as they're right at midfield in front of us here on senior night.
And conducted by Miss Heather Johnson, Bellefontaine Middle School Director of Bands.
Avila, Xander Kuhn, and the rest of the folks back in studio control. And it's, again, week 8 in high school football. Weeks 9 and 10, the Chiefs will be on the road at Kenton Ridge and at London. But no bigger game to date than right now. Jonathan Alder, under second-year head coach Nate Snedeker, has a good team. They're 5-2. They're pretty big, and they have an electric running back. If you're going to talk about Jonathan Alder football, a couple things come to mind. Tradition, they've played in state finals in years past. They're always good. But you also have to talk about Cameron Jewell. We saw him last year, Don. And I brought the box score from last year. It was really one of the rougher outings for the Chiefs the last couple of years. The Chiefs lost 42-7, but Jonathan Alder outgained them 474 yards to 114 yards. The quarterback, Tabor Headings, who has since graduated, was 9 of 9 for a touchdown. Cam Jewell, who didn't play all that game, they pulled the starters. He had 13 carries for 195 yards, and that's 15 yards a pop. Last week against Kenton Ridge, Jewell rushed for 373 yards. So, he's priority number one tonight.
Yeah, before we talk about Cameron Jewell, I got to say, Matt Hammond in the press box tonight. I feel like me and Hammond haven't watched a game together for like 25 years. It's almost like it's 1997 again. We both had a little more hair at the time and a little less stress in our lives, but it does feel like it's a flashback to the mid-90s.
Well, there's a lot of sports greatness right around
me. I mean, you can feel it. You can feel it in the press box tonight.
And I still remember, Matt, just a few weeks back when the Chiefs played Licking Heights, we were talking about the quarterback being all Ohio. And you said, well, was he first team, Bill? I said, I'm not sure. Matt was right on it immediately.
Always.
But
always. But you know, getting to the game tonight, I mean, Cameron Jewell, when we talked to Coach Brown this week, Coach Brown said that, you know, Jewell scares him just because he's a home run hitter, but he can also run it up in between the tackles. Yeah. And he thinks their offensive line is really physical, maybe one of the more physical offensive lines they've played this year. So it's going to be a good test for Bellefontaine. The one thing that the Chiefs have going for him is I don't think Jonathan Alder has much of a passing game. I mean, quarterback Doug Nussbaum has only thrown for 390 yards. He's got one touchdown and five picks. So, I mean, that tells me that there's probably not much going on in the air. You're going to see Coach Peitzmeier and Coach Bianski probably dial up a lot of run blitzes this week and try to use their speed to out-quick the big offensive line for Jonathan Alder.
Alder does have some big linemen. I walked past some of them when I came in a little after 6 o'clock tonight. Joel's not a real big guy, but he still is a physical runner, 5'10", 175. Coach Brown calls him a slasher. That's a great description, but he is a home run hitter. If he gets loose, the odds are nobody will catch him. I mean, he's just that fast. And it will be a rock'em, sock'em physical football game. You know, I think it was 2 years ago when Jonathan Alder came in here, and I thought had their best team. They won 38-8, but it was 28-0 after one quarter, and they kind of let off. That was a team that lost to Columbus DeSales in the regional finals during the COVID year. But, you know, I ask you who Alder reminds you of, and you gave a good answer. It was Wapakoneta a little bit and Tip City. You know, they're really physical. I think you kind of know what they're going to do. Their defense is very base. Rick Reed has talked about that. It's a 4-2-5. They don't blitz a lot, but they're going to make you earn it. I don't think we'll see as many big plays out of the Chiefs tonight, if I had to guess. We'll have to kind of, you know, 10 yards, 5 yards of dink and dunk down the field. Last week was, you know, we've been watching the Chiefs for about 30 years. That was a night where it was electric. I mean, it was just electric offensive football.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I still think Bellefontaine's going to hang their, you know, score in the 30s because there's just, like we've talked about week in and week out, I mean, you got to have a lot of athletes to cover the field when Bellefontaine's got the football. The question is, can Jonathan Alder stop Bellefontaine enough to stay in the game? I mean, Jewell might get a couple big touchdown runs, and he might be able to break a few, but can Jonathan Alder consistently keep the Bellefontaine offense at bay?
Good question. We're going to take a break, come back with the opening kick. The Chiefs 6-1, 2-0 in the CBC. The Alder Pioneers are 5-2, 1-1 in the CBC. We'll be back to set the table for Week 8 on Senior Night right after this on 107.3 The Drive and peakofohiotv.com.
Hungry after the game? Ready to celebrate the weekend? Ron's Pizza is open late tonight.
At Bellefontaine's Best Car Wash, we take care of your vehicle 100%, from the first drop of hot, clean water to the last stroke of our super soft, shine-enhancing towel. And you can choose from 4 levels of clean, basic, plus, premium, and ultimate, starting at just $8. Bellefontaine's Best Car Wash, 720 South Main.
Comer Insurance Agency in DeGraff offers insurance coverage for home, life, auto, commercial, and farm. Visit their website at comerinsuranceagency.com for their number and more information. Comer Insurance Agency, specializing in helping you with the right coverage.
Good luck to our Bellefontaine Chieftains football team and cheerleaders this season. We're excited and cheering for you, looking forward to an amazing season. This is Iron City Sports Bar, located at 1125 South Main Street in Bellefontaine, next to Dunkin' Donuts. Please stop by after the game or order ahead after online for convenient carryout online at ironcitysportsbar.com. You can also reach us at 937-404-5288. Home to the best wings, burgers, and steaks in Logan County.
Hungry after the game? Ready to celebrate the weekend? Ron's Pizza is open late tonight until 11 o'clock. Stop in for a hot, fresh pizza and an ice cold beer. Or call to pick it up at 292-7775. Pull up to the drive-thru window and you don't even have to get out of the car. They have specialty pizzas like buffalo chicken, chicken bacon ranch, taco, BLT, and barbecue chicken. They also offer cauliflower or broccoli and cheddar crusts. Ron's Pizza, South Main, Bellefontaine, 292-7775.
Welcome back to AccuSports Stadium. Thanks to Matt Comstock for hosting us tonight, the Bellefontaine High School Athletic Director. Again, Big Lou and Jason are here with peakofohiotv.com. This game is always on 107.3 The Drive, WPKO HD2 Bellefontaine, and your home of Bellefontaine Chieftain football, home and away. And down before we turn our attention to football, kind of a somber week around Bellefontaine and Coldwater. Lou Brunswick passed away a week ago today. It was on September 30th. Lou was 92 years old. He is survived by his wife, Ann, and his seven kids. You know, big family, well-known family, great family. And we know Mark very well. Mark is a teacher at Bellefontaine High, formerly the head baseball coach at Bellefontaine High. And I know you went to the funeral yesterday for Lou. And we talked about this last Friday. Lou is a very good friend of yours, somebody you looked up to. You wrote a book about Lou a few years ago. So, you know, we want to say, I guess, thank you to him for what he stood for in high school athletics.
Yeah, I mean, you know, he was a great coach, but he was an even better person and a great man. I think that everybody that ever had a chance to talk to him realizes how lucky they were. He leaves behind an incredible legacy of not just baseball victories, but of people that he's impacted in life. And, you know, I can't think of too many men that I've been lucky enough to actually write something about that have, you know, quite impacted me like Lou. And you know, it was a sad day, but I think it's also a day to celebrate
yes.
the incredible legacy and the incredible impact he's had on so many people.
And your book was Everyone Counts?
Everyone Counts, Faith, Family, and My Life in Baseball. And I think that order was exactly how he lived his life, you know, faith, family, and then baseball.
We're ready to tee it up. Alder in their road white uniforms, white pants. Charlie Oren puts his right foot into it. Kickoff brought to you by Dairy Queen of Bellefontaine, taken by the return man right at the 5-yard line. Look at a cut up field, breaks through a couple of tackles, and Riley Neer is cut down at the 22. As I looked at the kickoff, though, Don, I thought a couple of the Alder guys on our side beat the kicker to the ball. Now, if it's close, sometimes they won't call it, but I thought they were offsides, but no hanky.
Yeah, I mean, it's such, you know, sometimes that gets called, sometimes it doesn't. It's kind of like, it kind of used to be like the phantom play at second base on the double play.
Right. Warren with a decent kick down to about the 5. He's got 2 game-winning field goals in his career, by the way. He had one earlier this year and then had one last year as well. Chiefs will start at the 22. Alder in a 4-2-5. One of their safeties, Hank Shoemaker, plays kind of in the box area, though, so it kind of looks like a 4-3 right now. 11:55 to go in the opening quarter. St. Clair in shotgun. He'll hand to Fogan. Fogan's trying to run wide right. Works on a one tackle, still on his feet, going down the far sidelines, and it's a foot race. He's finally bumped out right around the Chieftain 45. It didn't look like there was much there, but he broke that first tackle and goes all the way from the left hash to the right sideline for a big gainer. See where they'll mark it out. I'll say at the 41, so a gain of 19 yards, and that's the speed. And boy, when Fogan gets going, look out for the Chieftain offense.
Yeah, I mean, Fogan's saying everybody can talk about Cameron Jewell all they want, but don't forget about me. I'm second in the league in rushing, and I've only played 5 games.
Chiefs with a big first down play. Now it's first and 10 at the Alder 41-yard line. Fogan went out of bounds, so it stopped the game clock. 11:48 to go in the opening quarter. We are scoreless. St. Clair wants to pass as time throws downfield, and it's picked off. Picked off at the Alder 44-yard line. The defensive back went down to his knee to pick it, so no return, but some miscommunication. Grant Horn, who's a sophomore corner, picked it, but miscommunication between St. Clair and the receiver. The receiver never looked back for the football, kept running his route.
Yeah, I think that St. Clair obviously thought it was going to be some kind of a post pattern, and Neer kept going deep. You know, and that's the kind of thing that Jonathan Alder is going to need to do is get some turnovers. I mean, that's only the 3rd interception that St. Clair's thrown all season.
Yeah. And it was just a communication issue on that play.
Yeah.
Well, Alder's got great field position. Jewel gets the give, trying to run wide to the right side, trying to show off that speed, and hit right around the 50-yard line on the far side. Coming up was Keelan Oregon. So a gain of 6. 11:37 to go in the opening quarter. No score, but Alder with the momentum right now and possession.
Well, I think that was a little bit of a maybe breakdown on defense, too, because I know Bellefontaine does not want Jewel to get to the boundary. I think that keeping him in between the tackles is going to be a priority tonight.
Yeah, the word of the week from Coach Brown was leverage. Leverage, leverage. And that means keep him inside, as Don said. second and four. And this time, Nussbaum, the quarterback, keeps it. He's got a running lane, and he's got a first down. He play fake to Joel, and all the eyes on the defense went with the speedy tailback. And Nussbaum, the quarterback, just rumbled right up left guard for 7 yards. First down to the Chieftain 43. That was pretty easy.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of that read option for Jonathan Alder.
Yeah, they like to ground and pound. They don't pass much. Don said that before the game started. Here comes Jewel running around the right side, trying to bounce it outside. Oh, he cuts it back inside and cut down after a gain of maybe two. He did well to get that. Caden Reams came up from the safety. Chiefs that time did a much better job stringing it out, gain of 2, 2nd and 8.
Yeah, in that play, they kind of ran that student body right a little bit. They pulled the backside guard and tackle.
Yeah.
And Bellefontaine's pursuit from the backside. They're gonna run away from Hayden Manns as much as they can tonight. He had an incredible game last week, and yeah. He seems like he's getting tougher to block week in and week out.
I agree with you. 2nd and 8, he's the Chiefs' defensive tackle. Here comes Jewel out of the I formation. Hit and spins after contact for another couple down to the Chieftain 37-yard line. Keegan Overton-Story, one of those seniors doing double duty tonight. Playing offensive line and defensive line, made the tackle. Xander Johnson, Chieftain tackle, unable to play tonight. He's an offensive starter, a little bit of a knee issue. So.
That's a big blow for the Chiefs because Xander's played a really important left tackle position for him all year.
Yeah. Third and a long three for the Pioneers at the Chieftain 37. No score. Here comes Jewel looking to get a hole, and he has that hole, and he's got a first down. Well, he's hard to get a good hit off on. He's elusive. First down run just inside the 30, maybe the 29.5, gain of about 7.5 yards. That will make it 8 yards. And a first down for the Pioneers. They have yet to throw the football. It's been very base offense, but they're blocking pretty well up front.
Yeah, Bellefontaine opening their 4-3 defense. They've got Manns on one side, Ashcraft on the other.
This quarter and all the quarters brought to you by Roof and Benchick Law. Roof and Benchick is in Kenton. No score. Here comes Jewel running left. Works out of a couple of tackles, cuts it back. He's into the open field, inside the 15, 10, 5, and he will go into the end zone as he reverses field and scores it on a 29-yard run. Cut back, and he had good vision, and he had great speed to take it to the end zone over by the right pylon. Alder strikes first. They make the interception pay off. They go 56 yards all on the ground, capped off by a 29-yard run by Cameron Jewel. Alder leads at 6-0 with 9:43 to go in the opening quarter.
Yeah, the first 2.5 minutes are everything Bellefontaine was worried about. Jewel getting loose and turning the football over.
Extra point by Oren is up. And he knocks it through. A point after touchdown thanks to Fissel floor covering on South Main and Bellefontaine. We'll take a break. 9:43 to go in the opening quarter. Jonathan Alder leads Bellefontaine 7-0 on the Quest Federal Credit Union High School football scoreboard. More after this on 107.3 The Drive and peakofohiotv.com.
Hi, it's Liz at Bellefontaine's Comfort Inn. Our Fountain Lounge is Bellefontaine's fun night spot. And right now, we're looking for an experienced bartender who will enjoy working in our fun atmosphere. If you like people, you'll love working at Comfort Inn. Apply in person or call 599-5555.
Bartenders at the Comfort Inn earn more than $9 an hour, and that's plus tips. If you're an experienced mixologist, check out the Fountain Lounge experience. Apply in person at the Comfort Inn where 68 meets 33 or call during business hours at 599-5555.
The second play of the game picked off by Alder. And the Pioneers won on a pretty quick 56-yard scoring drive. It was culminated by Cameron Jewel with a 29-yard touchdown run. Alder leads Bellefontaine 7-0 with 9:43 to go in the opening quarter.
Yeah, a little bit of a gut check here early on after that miscue in the passing game and then the inability to stop Jewel. 5 carries already for close to 50 yards.
Oren to kick it off, brought to you by Dairy Queen of Bellefontaine. It's a high kick, pretty good one, taken by Neer at the 4. Looking for a seam, looking to work out of a block, and he does that. Now looking to run wide right, reverses field, and will be brought down around the 27-yard line. Good kick by Oren, though. He kicked it high and deep down to about the 4. And the Chiefs have some work to do. You know, the offensive issue, I know nobody wants to see turnovers. That's probably the biggest stat coaches look at, but that's fixable. I'll look for that to happen again where they're not on the same play call offensively. But the defense was concerning to me.
Yeah. Jewel cut through them pretty easy there.
First and 10. Chiefs thrown 27, a 23-yard return by Neer. Chiefs trailing 7-0, wing to the right. And they'll give it to Fogan, who works out of one tackle and then brought down. Really no gain. Good job by Alder, flowing to the football over on the right side of the line. 9:23 to go in the opening quarter. Alder in front 7-0.
Yeah, Bellefontaine's going to have to block better than that. They didn't get anything moving up front. And Jonathan Alder's got a pretty stout defensive line, too. Mm-hmm. They're pretty solid on the defensive side of the ball.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That 4-2-5, but one of the safeties right up by the line right now. Kind of more of a 4-3, I'll call it. Fogan goes in motion to the left side, so an empty set. They'll throw it out to Deitch, who makes the catch, gets a block, works out of one tackle, then dives forward up to about the 34. Still short of the first down. Gain of 7, but it makes it manageable. 3rd and 4, and the Chiefs will go no huddle.
Yeah, Coach Kennedy likes the no huddle to keep Jonathan Alder's personnel on the field.
Now Mann's in as a wing to the right. 3rd and 3, we'll call it. St. Clair looks over to the bench. Chiefs down 7-0. 3rd and 3 at their own 34. Pretty big play early on in this game. And it's a fake to Fogan. They'll throw out to Manns, who's open in the flat. Breaks out of one tackle. Looking to break out of another tackle. And the big guy just rumbles to about the 46-yard line. Misdirection. They fake to give to Fogan. Manns then went in the left flat as he ran the pattern from his right to his left. He was wide open and an easy one. First down, Chiefs to the 46, gain of 12 yards.
Yeah, this last week we were talking on the Coach's Corner show about Hayden Manns and you know, his size and his ability to play up front. They talked about wanting to get him the football a little bit, and right out of the gate, a little wrinkle that Jonathan Alder obviously hasn't seen on tape.
Yeah, first time we've seen it all year. He's athletic. Here's a pop pass to Fogan. Look at her run left to right. Gets into the secondary, and he'll burst forward to the Alder 47-yard line. Just a simple pop pass as he went in motion left to right, and he's got that speed, then cut it up at the exact right moment. That is a gain of, we'll call it 8, 2nd and 2. Well, the Chiefs looking pretty sharp this possession.
Yeah, Fogan's tough on that little pop pass because he's already got a full head of steam when he gets the football, and everybody else is coming from a set position.
2nd and 2 for the Chiefs at the Alder 47. Man of motion is Fogan. They fake to give to him. Manns instead gets the pop pass, and it won't go for much. He lost maybe half a yard. Well, they tried to get creative, but Alder was ready this time. Tackling Manns takes a man. It takes three guys to get him down.
Yeah, it's too bad, really, that Fogan didn't get the ball there because I think that's a big gainer for him.
You're right. Well, 3rd and 3 now at the Alder 47. 3rd and a short 3.
One thing that's really interesting is Jonathan Alder, throughout the game, has really kind of been up in press coverage on the wideouts.
That's true. 3rd and 3, St. Clair wants to pass, throws. Caught by Deitch, he's got the first down. Just that slant pattern, I call it a square in. Takes it right to the middle of the field, and it's a first down. It's not a big gainer, but it's an important gain. First down to the 42-yard line, a gain of 5, and that's what Deitch does. He runs great routes, and he catches the football.
Well, if Jonathan Alder's going to be in press coverage, you can't let the wide receiver cross your face like that. That's why you're in press coverage.
Yeah, well, now they back off. Now the corners are about 8 yards off. 1st and 10 for the Chiefs at the Alder 42. Chiefs trail 7-0. St. Clair wants to pass, has pressure, runs away from it, throws downfield, has a man wide open, caught at the 10-yard line. It's Reams. What a job by St. Clair to improvise. He had pressure right in his face, saw it quickly, rolled left, and Reams got behind the secondary. Had to go down to a knee to catch it at the 9, but it's 1st and goal Chiefs. That's a big one. That's our first RV Wholesalers long-distance connection of the game for the Chiefs, a gain of some 33 yards.
I think Jonathan Alder's defensive back thought he was going to run with it, and they started to come up, and that's when he was able to find Reams open at the 10.
And if Reams didn't have to go down to a knee, I think he may have scored. 1st and goal for the Chiefs at the Alder 9. Bellefontaine trails 7-0, 5:55 to go in the opening quarter. Fogan off to St. Clair's left side. And St. Clair wants to pass again, throws into coverage, incomplete. right around the 6-yard line. Tried to hit Wilson on the right hash. That just did not have a good look to it.
Yeah, the outside linebacker was sitting in there and made things a little bit interesting. I think I'd like to see Chris Fogan get a shot here. Especially him getting to the boundary. His speed is something that's going to give Jonathan Alder defense some fits.
Second to go with the 9. Here is Fogan running right between the tackles. Not much there. Maybe got a yard. Good play inside by Alder. Chiefs down 7-0, 5:28 to go in the opening quarter.
In the last few weeks, what we've seen in this kind of situation is a little bit of a jump ball to C.J. Wilson out there on the edge. He's on the far side, but St. Clair feels confident in Wilson's ability to go up and win the 50-50 balls.
No doubt. Third and goal at the 8. Chiefs down 7-0. St. Clair rolls right, looking, looks for near, throws end zone, and he dropped the football. He had it. He had the defender beat and dropped it about 3 yards deep over by the right side, the right pylon, and it will bring up 4th and goal at the 8 and a decision for Coach Brown early in this game.
Yeah, if you're going to win these kind of games, you got to make those kind of plays. And you said he dropped it. I couldn't really tell from here whether he dropped it or it was a great play by the defensive back. But big decision for Coach Brown early.
Looks like there will be a timeout taken by the Chiefs. We'll take a timeout as well. 5 minutes to go in the opening quarter. Chiefs trail 7-0. They will talk about a 4th and goal play. We'll come back with more after this.
Who's open after the game tonight? Donato's Pizza on South Main Bell Fountain is open until midnight. Order online at donatos.com for pickup or delivery. Donato's Pizza, every piece is important. South Main Bell Fountain and online at donatos.com. Dairy Queen in Urbana now has the new Fall Blizzards. Cinnamon Roll Centers with soft cinnamon roll pieces and brown butter cinnamon topping. Or Pumpkin Pie. Pumpkin pie pieces blended with vanilla soft serve topped with whipped topping and nutmeg. Hurry, they're only here for a limited time.
Back at AccuSports Stadium, Coach Brown and his offense have talked about it, and they have decided to try a field goal attempt by Alex Crable. Riley Near will hold it. Brody Boy will snap it. This is a 25-yarder from the left hash. Chiefs trying to get points on this possession. Good snap. The ball is put down. The kick is up, and the kick is no good. It hit the right upright and bounced out. So a tough start for the Chiefs. They continue to trail at 7-0. It was a pretty good drive until they got the 1st and goal at the 9. And an incompletion, a 1-yard run, another incompletion. And then they tried the field goal, which was very similar to the game winner a couple of weeks ago. That was a 26-yarder. This was a 25-yarder. Crable's very solid, but pushed a little bit too far to the right.
Yeah, snap and hold were good. Yeah, he just and he got a good kickoff.
He did.
Hit the upright.
He hit
flushed
it well.
Flushed it too. Hit it dead center.
He did. I thought it was going to go in, but Alder leads it 7-0. They'll now start at their 20 after the miss. And Jewell hit and brought down after he got about 3. There wasn't much there that time.
Well, I'll tell you, usually, the first series, teams like to sit in their base defense, see if they can play just base and stop teams. I think you're going to see Bellefontaine taking a lot more gambles on a defense now with some run blitzes, shooting their linebackers from different angles, trying to get a disruptive play to put Jonathan Alder behind the down and distance.
Second and 6 after a 4-yard gain right between the tackles by Cameron Jewell. Nussbaum in shotgun and Jewell right behind him with 3 receivers. And it will be a give to Jewell again, showing off that speed. Hit a couple of times, then brought down by a host of tacklers right around the 29. Well, they gave him a nice spot. I didn't think he got quite that far, but it will be 3rd and 1 on the next play.
Yeah, Bellefontaine needs to find a way to, sneak somebody in there, make a big play. They got to get this big guy off the field. He's going to get a penalty.
And
he did.
They do.
You got to sprint off the field, I'm telling you.
Jogging
off the field is not going to get it done.
Yeah, one of the linemen was a little bit late. It was a 1-yard run by Nussbaum, but 12 men on the field on the Chiefs.
Yeah, Jonathan Alder went right to the line. They saw what was happening and quickly snapped it.
Yeah, smart play.
They're going to get the 5-yard penalty.
Illegal substitution on the defense. Yep, the official on it, 12 men on the field. So that'll move it to the 34, so 5-yard freebie. Tough start for the Chiefs tonight. It's just not all clicking. The offense has had 2 possessions, has not scored. an interception on the second play of the game on a long drive where they were held out of the end zone and missed the field goal when it hit the right upright. One of those nights where you're just going to have to dig in.
Well, I was going to, you know, talked about that a little bit and the fact that was there going to be a hangover from last week's game. And, you know, Bellefontaine hasn't been as sharp as they've been the last few weeks.
And Coach Brown, that was a practice yesterday right at the end. He really challenged them, too. I think he kind of thought about that. And Nussbaum fakes the give. He wants to run, and he's hit by a sea of black jerseys after he got maybe two. Nussbaum's not a real big guy, but he's one of their leaders. And that was a two-yard run where he paid for it. Alder continues to lead this game 7-0, 3:28 to go in the opening quarter.
See, second and eighth, the down and distance where I think you'll see somebody blitzed or something that where you can kind of maybe see if you can get a disruptive play in the offensive backfield. Even a, you know, no gain would be good for Bellefontaine to keep it at third and eight.
They're a power spread offense. Wingman to the left. I got to think this is going to Joel. Now the wing goes in motion. Here's a give to Joel, trying to run right between the tackles. Dives forward and takes it to about the 39. Gain of four. Then a late flag thrown by the back judge. Pardew with the tackle. That flag came 2 seconds after Joel was down on the ground.
Yeah, it was some pushing and shoving in the defensive backfield, and not sure which way this one's going.
Maybe not either.
It's first going against Bellefontaine.
Well.
So you finally, you finally get a position where you're third and six, and a kid goes and makes a post play foul. You know, it's those 15 yarders that will drive coaches nuts.
Yeah, it's all the way now from the Alder 40 to the Chieftain 45. Alder has a fresh set of downs.
I mean, let's face it, it's a safety and a wide receiver hitting each other. They're not impacting the play at all.
I know. But that kind of stuff has been a point of emphasis all season by officiating crews. Now wing goes in motion for Alder. The Chiefs show a blitz. Here they come. Joel bounces out of a couple of tackles. Then he's hit hard by Hayden Manns and a host of Chiefs and brought back down. Got maybe about two.
Yeah, I don't think that last call was a bad officiating. I think you just got to be smarter than that if you're Bellefontaine.
Yeah, they've had a rough first quarter. 2:25 to go in the first quarter. Alder leads it 7-0. Just a 1 yard run. They brought pressure that time. It was a blitz off the edge, and Don said it a few minutes ago. I think Bellefontaine will continue to become more and more aggressive, especially when Alder gets to this side of the 50.
Yeah, I think they've got to because they can't stop Joel just sitting in their base.
Second and nine. Nussbaum wants to pass. Looking, throwing, as a man who dropped the football. He was wide open by the Bellefontaine bench at the 32, and that will set up third and nine. Unable to haul it in was Wyatt Kaiser, who was open. And now it's third and nine. Chieftain defense needs to dig in.
Well, Wyatt's probably only got about three passes all year. He was surprised the ball got to him, Bill. I mean, he's used to run blocking. That's why he's out there.
Well, he was wide open. Third and nine. Would you guess pass again? I could see a potential run.
Yeah, well.
Because it could be four down territory, maybe. Third and nine. Nussbaum wants to pass. Has time. Throws downfield. It's a little high and it's incomplete. Overshot his receiver at the Chieftain 35-yard line. It was just too high for Jonathan Beckel.
I think that's the importance of getting the right down and distance for Bellefontaine is because if Nussbaum wants to throw 30 times today, Bellefontaine would be pleased. It's the second and five, third and threes that they're worried about. You get them in third and eight, and they got, you know, it's not what they like to be.
Wyatt Kaiser, the punter, stands at his own 42. Chiefs punt returner standing back at the 5-yard line. It's a short punt over towards the far sideline, but a very effective punt. Flies out around the 10. That's a heck of a punt that time by Kaiser. A punt of 34 yards and no return. Chiefs will have to start at their 10. They do get a stop, though. We'll keep it right here. And Alder leads the Chiefs 7-0.
That was good old-fashioned punting right there, Bill. That was Ray Guy angling it down towards the corner. Now we got all this soccer, rugby stuff that's spinning the ball. And, I mean, it's good old stuff when Ray Guy used to just angle it to the corner. Yep. Ray Guy, you know, for those that are listening, he was played in the 70s, and Most of you weren't born yet, but those that were, that's how they used to punt.
For the Oakland Raiders, John Madden was his coach. He was a great one. Chiefs, they'll have 90 yards to go. St. Clair starts, toss play to Fogan, running to his left. Has a seam, 20, 25, up the left sideline. Still on his feet, reverses field, cut down at the 35-yard line. Then a late flag thrown after the tackle. And the official right there talking to Jason Brown about what happened. It's a 26-yard run, one of our RV wholesalers' long-distance connections of the game.
Sideline infraction, I bet.
We'll see.
Yes.
Yeah, Don's on it.
The streak continues.
Sideline
warning.
It's the streak.
It's the Cal Ripken streak of football. Yeah. The Bellefontaine Chieftains have roughly 70 straight games now of a sideline warning.
Yeah, sometimes it's early in the game. Here we are, late first quarter, 1:41 to go. Chiefs trailing 7-0, first and 10 at their 36. Just a toss play to Fogan. Very well blocked, by the way.
Yeah, huge hole.
First and 10. Fogan goes in motion. And
motion on Buffon. You know, I think that Jonathan Alder, obviously after the game that Bellefontaine had last week, came in prepared to stop the pass, but you can't forget about Chris Fogan. He's a game breaker in his own right.
Well, Coach Snedeker said that one of his goals was to make the Chiefs one-dimensional. And usually when coaches say that, they're trying to take away the run, but Bellefontaine passed so prolifically last week, 412 yards. And Alder's mixed their coverages up. Sometimes they've been press coverage right after the receiver, as Don mentioned. Sometimes they drop back. Now they're right up on the receiver. First and 15 after that five-yard penalty. Fogan goes in motion to the left. St. Clair wants to pass. Has pressure. Looking to get rid of it. Throws into coverage. And Fogan makes
the catch.
By the Bellefontaine bench at the 38. What a touch pass by St. Clair. An even better catch by Fogan. Fogan's got great hands. And they'll mark him down at the 39. So a gain of 8. There wasn't much there other than pressure in St. Clair's face.
That was straight up backyard football right there. You know, go down to the cherry tree, button hook. I'm going to flip it to you. And Fogan got both feet down like he's been playing wide receiver his whole life.
Yeah, that was great last week. A one-handed touchdown catch. And that makes it 2nd and 7 for the Chiefs at their own 39, down 7-0 with a minute to go in the opening quarter. St. Clair has pressure, steps away from it. Now he's got some green grass, 45-50, and it'll go out of bounds right by his bench at the Alder 48-yard line, and it's a first down. That's awareness right there. That's a guy that's really, really got things figured out. When you can step up, and he ran at exactly the right time.
Well, if Jonathan Alder wants to try to play man defense, that's got to be part of the weapon right there. They had their backs turned to him all running with receivers, and I just like the fact that he stepped out of bounds there.
I know you like that. 13-yard gain, first and 10 for the Chiefs at the Alder 48. St. Clair gives it to Fogan, trying to run to his left. Breaks through some tackles. Fogan still on his feet and will finally be knocked out right around the Alder 34-yard line. And that's another first down run. Chiefs blocking well into the boundary. First down run for Fogan that goes for 14. Chiefs in a rhythm right now.
Bellefontaine likes running the short side tonight. It's always one less guy to block, and you know, they're running that little counter action there. Big holes so far.
Alex Caudill starting for Jazander Johnson, a left tackle. Caudill not a big tackle, but he's just an outstanding football player.
Yeah, he's got a little bit of a nasty streak too, you know, that also helps up there.
First and 10, St. Clair wants to pass. Well, has pressure, gets away from that pressure. Looking, still looking downfield, throws. And it's incomplete right around the 10-yard line. Long developing play.
And late flag on the defensive backfield.
Yeah, it is. Down around the Alder 19-yard line. St. Clair had some pressure up the middle, but rolled away from it. Gave his receiver a chance. I think it was near he tried to hit who was running towards the Alder bench.
Maybe defensive holding, maybe?
That would be my
guess. Pass interference on Bellefontaine?
Really? Wow.
What?
Wow.
Not sure I saw that.
Wow. Huh. Well, here comes the call from you.
He wasn't even around the pass.
Yeah, C.J. Wilson says what? And I don't blame him.
C.J. Wilson isn't the only one saying what. Coach Brown
is emphatically saying
what plus some other words.
Yeah. But that's like the old drive killer, because instead of 2nd and 10, it's now.
It's a 15-yard penalty in high school. I mean,
first and 25. Chiefs will be back at their own 49. 38 seconds to go in the first quarter. Chiefs down 7-0. That's been a challenging first quarter. They've moved the ball at times. But a turnover and a missed field goal. Here comes Fogan over the left side, darting into the secondary. Still on his feet, gets a push from his offensive line, and he takes it all the way down to the 37. What a physical run. He'll go for 14 over the left side, and the Chiefs get most of that penalty yardage back. Boy, Fogan looks sharp tonight. He's running with some great authority.
Well, he's carried six times, and four of them have been for over 10 yards.
Second and...
about 70 plus yards so far for Fogan.
Second and 11, we'll call. So that was a 14-yarder. Ball's at the 37. Chiefs will let the game clock go to zeros. That's the end of the first quarter. Chiefs are moving, but they still trail after one. Here on senior night at Bellefontaine High on the Quest Federal Credit Union High School Football Scoreboard. Jonathan Alder 7, Bellefontaine nothing. Back with more after this.
If you are experiencing a poor flush and or drain backup, call Bobcat Multiworks now and have your septic system pumped. While they are doing that, they will also inspect your system, hopefully preventing a large replacement fee. Call today for more information, 585-9904.
Many can say they're the best, but only Firehouse Pizza has been voted the best pizza in Logan County. Check out our specials and menu on our Facebook page at facebook.com/Firehouse Pizza and Subs. Firehouse Pizza and Subs in Zanesfield, voted number one in Logan County.
Are you penalized because your bank's head coach is located out of town? At the People Savings Bank, our head coach is right here in your hometown to help you meet your goals. Come score a touchdown with the People Savings Bank. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Welcome you back to the second quarter tonight on 107.3 The Drive and peakofohiotv.com. This game also streamed at peakofohio.com. All over the globe, chance to listen and watch us. The Bellefontaine Chiefs trail 7-0 as we begin the second quarter with Jonathan Alder in town. Second and 11 from the Alder 37. St. Clair wants to pass, throws towards the sideline, caught by his receiver. Between the hash and the sideline at the 30, it was near going down to a knee. And that will make it third and about four. Chiefs quickly back to the line. Plenty of time, play clock is at 29.
Hayden Mann's jump for that. I think Mann's thought he was the intended receiver there.
I know. Good effort, but it was too. Yeah. It was not to him. Near made the catch. 7 yards, third and four for the Chiefs. Look over at the play call, the motion in from Jake Kennedy and staff. Third and four at the Alder 30. Chiefs down 7-0. It's a give to Fogan, who gets a seam. Then he's hit in a hole and brought back by a couple of Alder Pioneers. And well, they'll say he only got a yard. I thought maybe he got a couple. Not now, fourth and three for the Chiefs.
Nice play by the Jonathan Alder outside linebacker there. You know, one thing about having near at that H-back is he's leading a lot of these plays up into the hole. 33 did a nice job there of shedding that block and making the tackle.
Now an empty set. Chiefs need to pick this up. Fourth and three at the Alder 29. Need to get to the 26. St. Clair in an empty set throws. Receiver there makes the catch, and he's got the first down. Another one of those square ends over by the left hash. Caught by Deitch. He's the first down maker. Gain of eight. It's a first down for the Chiefs.
He is the possession receiver for Bellefontaine. I think Wes Welker back in the day with the Patriots. He runs those precision routes and has great hands.
Yep. And a perfect pass by St. Clair. First and 10 for the Chiefs at the Alder 21. Fogan in the backfield with St. Clair. Fogan with a reverse. And this time they got near, who's looking to run, throws towards the end zone, and he overshoots his receiver.
We interference
right around the goal line. It is interference. Little razzle dazzle.
I would have liked to see near keep the football. I think he might have had a touchdown if he kept.
Yeah, he could have run. You're right. But that's, I don't think, what the play called for when they sent in the play call. A run to the left by Fogan. He tosses it back to Neer, who was going from left to right. Neer, a right-handed passer and a backup quarterback. Look for a receiver down around the five. Overshot him, but it will be a defensive penalty on the Alder Pioneers.
Yeah. It'll be interesting to talk to Kennedy after the game to see if Neer has a run option there, because if he does, I think he probably could have ran it down inside the 10.
Yeah. And the Chiefs will start just outside the 10. So the penalty moves it from the 21 to inside the 11 to about the 10 and a half. Grant Horn called for the pass interference. He had the interception earlier to start the game. He's one of the older corners. First and 10 for the Chiefs at the 10 and a half. Belfountain trails 7-0. Here goes Fogut over the left side in that counter play. Not much doing. And Belfountain, that's one of their best running plays, but I'm sure the other team's defense puts much preparation to take away the counter. Only a gain of about a yard and a half.
I'd like to see Belfountain go back to some of that reverse action just because it was wide open.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe not on the nine.
Yeah, this is where you need a couple really productive plays. 9:40 to go in a half. Alder leads the Chiefs 7-0. Belfountain in need of a touchdown. They've moved the ball up and down the field tonight.
This is where he likes Deitch on the square end.
St. Clair wants to pass. Looking, throws end zone. Back shoulder fade. It's incomplete by the left pylon on the far side. Tried to hit Wilson, who was in man coverage. Grant Horn, the defender, incomplete. A little bit shallow. The pass is just off. And now it's third and 8 for the Chiefs at the Alder 9-yard line.
Well, I think on that, Wilson got too deep. On a play yeah. like that, it's usually he's going to throw it to the pylon, and Wilson was a little bit deep in the end zone there.
About 3 yards deep. You're right. This is a big play for the Chiefs.
I still think you might see Deitch on some sort of a skinny post after Fogan runs that safety out of there.
Landon Kelly now wing to the right. St. Clair by himself in the backfield. Has time, looks, throws end zone, and it's knocked away by Alder. Well done. Well done by Grant Horn. Tried to hit Deitch right by the goalpost. 4th and 8 at the Alder 9. And the Chiefs, think about it.
They're going.
They're going.
You know, usually in high school football, the kicker gets one shot. And if you don't connect, your chances are probably not as good the next time.
Well, and the ball's right in the middle of the field. But I think they just want a touchdown, too. I mean, they've been there already and had the field goal that went off the upright. 4th and 8 at the Alder 9. St. Clair wants to pass. Has time. Throws end zone towards his man. And
what a
make
throw.
The catch. Oh, what a catch over the left corner.
Chris Fogan.
Touchdown to Chris Fogan over on the far left side on the Alder sidelines. And what a pass by St. Clair. Threw it over top of the defense with great touch. A 9-yard touchdown pass from St. Clair to Fogan. And that's something you see on Saturdays and Sundays, not too often on Friday nights, if you know what I mean. Chiefs an extra point away from tying it. What a pass by St. Clair.
Well, I think it was a great catch, too. Don't forget that Fogan's a running back, and that was a nice route, though, against that linebacker.
Neer puts the ball down, and the extra point is up, and it is good by Crable. Tie ball game, 9:20 to go in the opening half. Belfountain 7, Jonathan Alder 7 on a great touchdown pass and catch from St. Clair to Fogan. Back with another kickoff after this.
As a member-owned financial institution, we stack the deck in your favor. Fewer fees, more frees. Quest Federal Credit Union puts our owners in a position to succeed by offering more opportunities to save where others choose to ding you for every service. Quest Federal Credit Union, member-owned since 1969. Bank better. Quest Federal Credit Union, explore the possibilities. NCUA insured, membership eligibility required, equal opportunity lender.
Back at AccuSports Stadium, 9-yard touchdown pass from St. Clair to Fogan has given the Chieftains sidelines some life. Belfountain's moved the football up and down the field tonight, but they had an interception. They also had a missed field goal, and they finally make that drive pay off. It was a 90-yard touchdown drive that took part of the first quarter and second quarter. The Chiefs and Jonathan Alder tied up at 7 apiece. Kickoff brought to you by Dairy Queen of Belfountain, taken by Alder at the 7-yard line. Looking to return it up the field. The return man kind of horse-collared right by his neck at about the 28-yard line, and that's where Alder will start. Return of about 19 yards. Tonight's game also brought to you in part by Comfort Inn. Click on the Comfort Inn ad at peakofohio.com for radio listener-only savings on room rates. Also thanks to Iron City Sports Bar on South Main of Belfountain, home of Logan County's best wings, burgers, and steaks. This quarter and all the quarters of Chieftain football brought to you by Roof and Benchick Law. Roof and Benchick is in Kenton. Chiefs and Alder tied up at 7. 1st and 10 for Alder at their own 28. Nussbaum in shotgun. Gives it to Jewell, who's going through a couple of defenders, and then brought down by a host. That's gang tackling. Still got about 3.5. I think one thing that's underrated about Jewel is his strength.
Yeah, he's got forward lean when he gets hit. Right now I've got St. Clair 10 of 15 for 94. Now, Brian Lorette's not here. I usually lean heavily on him. Hammond's in his spot, so we're going to see if Hammond can, you know, continue the flawless statistic play of Lorette for the last few weeks.
4-yard run by Jewel, 2nd and 6. Coming up in a moment, we'll spotlight our Clark State team members of the week. This game a 7-7 tie with 8:35 to go in the half. Here's Jewel again trying to run outside, trying to get away from the Chieftain defense, and he will on the far sideline, then tiptoe for a first down to about the 39, gain of 7. Our Clark State team members of the week this week, Matt Mott, senior offensive lineman for the Chiefs, and Theo Reminder, who's a junior drum major, one of the band leaders. Got a chance to see the bands at the half tonight for Jonathan Alder and Bellefontaine.
You can tell that Joel's got some speed because Bellefontaine has taken some really bad angles so far. That was another one where it seemed like the defensive back maybe had him squared up. He just didn't take a good angle.
No. 7-yard run. Here comes Jewel again trying to run right up the middle. Got about 5. It's a power spread. And one of the questions I ask the opposing coach each week before the game is, what's your run-pass ratio? How often will you throw it? And Coach Snedeker said, well, for our team, probably about 80-20.
80-20. He's lying to you, Bill. I think it was more like 97-3. I mean, he's throwing, the quarterback's throwing 72 times. We're in week 8.
2nd and 5. Well, if it's working, keep running the play.
Yeah.
Wingman in motion. Here's Jordan's hit hard in the backfield. Wow. Loss of 2.
Guess who? Alex Caudill.
Yeah, Caudill from that middle backer spot. And Sullivan Ashcraft, too. That is a Chieftain sandwich that is good for the Chiefs, but not good for the opposing ball carrier. Loss of about 2.5, and not just the loss of
what
yardage. The collision, you could feel it all the way up here. 3rd and 7 for the Alder Pioneers at their own 42-yard line.
Jules flexed out and still trying to adjust his face mask.
Nussbaum rolls left. Has some pressure. Ooh. Hit, and then he's brought down. Hit at first by Caudill, who made the play. Then his teammate wrapped it up for a loss all the way back to the 32-yard line. Yeah, maybe we'll make it the 33-yard line. By Caudill, for a guy that's really never played linebacker in high school, he is an outstanding football player.
And he'll come get you, too. And that was a – he won't get credit for the sack, but he definitely was the disruptor. I'm not sure who made the actual tackle. Doesn't really matter because Caudill spun him around.
Well, Nussbaum dropped back, and he just did not have a chance. That is the Dairy Queen Blizzard Blitz sack of the night. Low snap to the punter who gets it out of there. That's Kaser. The Chiefs return man comes up.
Yes.
See, you're saying yes. I don't know that Coach Brown's saying yes.
Yes, finally a return man came up and didn't let it bounce another 20 yards.
Well,
attaboy, CJ.
CJ Wilson with rolling the dice, but it paid off. He caught it on the hop with some enemy fire coming his way.
Well, that's one of those ones where the coach is like, no, good play.
Yeah. Chiefs start at their 34, though, and they got a huge defensive stop. Now Bellefontaine's got the momentum.
Yeah. I mean, again, when Bellefontaine's been able to get him into that down and distance of 3rd and 8, 3rd and long, they've been able to get off the field.
1st and 10 for the Chiefs at their own 34-yard line, 7-7 game, 6:31 to go in a half. Toss play to Fogan, looking to get a block on the side by Kelly. He gets that block, and then Fogan takes it upfield close to the marker to about the 43-yard line. They've liked the toss play tonight. Actually, their perimeter runs have been better than their counter inside runs, I think, so far, Don.
Yeah, they don't really have much of an answer for Fogan coming right off tackle like that.
Gain of 9 to the 43-yard line, 6:08 to go in the half.
Fogan with about 84 yards so far tonight and just 9 carries.
2nd and 1. Maybe a play where you can air it deep. Chiefs look over for the play call on the sidelines. Play clock down to 10. 7-7 our score between Bellefontaine and Jonathan Alder. St. Clair will give it to Fogan, who's hit and then upended. What a physical tackle. He got the first down, but paid for it. And one of the Alder Knights slow to get up off the ground. Big collision in the hole. Fogan appears to be fine. He got lifted up off his feet.
Result of the play is the first down for the Chieftains.
First down run to the 45, only 2 yards, but it is a first down.
Yeah, I think Bellefontaine would like to milk a little bit of this clock on this drive here and, you know, get in the end zone right before the half. They're not in a huge hurry.
No, you're right. 7-7 our score. Other scores at peakofohio.com. Vogan goes in motion. He'll throw out to him. And he makes the catch. Still on his feet inside the open field and will be team tackled around the 43. Kind of bobbled initially. He's got great hands. Then brought it back in. First down to about the 42. Gain of 13 that time. That was easy. Just threw it out to him on the perimeter when he went in motion.
Boy, he makes a difference in this offense.
Oh, yeah.
You know, the thing we talked about last week was it makes a difference because not only is he out there and he's a great player, but it keeps Neer on the outside, too, and just another weapon for Bellefontaine to pick and choose from.
Mm-hmm. First and 10 for the Chiefs at the Alder 42, 7-7 game. St. Clair wants to throw a deep one, takes a shot down the right side. Deitch is there. Deitch fighting for the football, and it's incomplete right around the 11-yard line. Good battle between Fennec and Deitch around the Alder 12 on a deep shot on the right sideline on the near side, second and 10.
You know, I kind of like Kennedy taking his shot here in this plus field position, especially on first down. You got to keep the defense honest with a couple of the deep balls, especially the safeties who like to tend to, you know, they tend to creep up a little bit, especially when you got a running back closing in on 100 in the first half.
Yeah. Fennec now pressing C.J. Wilson, who's to the right side. Fogan brought down right, well, behind the line of scrimmage. Tried an inside run, not much there. Third and 10. Croninger with another tackle. He's been active. Thought we'd see a little bit more scoring tonight. Now, Bellefontaine's moved it some. Here we are, closing in close to halftime. 4:10 to go in the second quarter, 7-7 game. Third and 10 for the Chiefs. Need to work up some magic here on a tough down and distance. St. Clair in shotgun with Fogan off to his left. St. Clair wants to pass. Has time, throws, and it's caught by his receiver who had to bobble it. Fennec in coverage, it's down to the 38, but only a gain of about four. Fourth and 6 for the Chiefs. Do they go or do they punt? We'll send out the punt team. I'll tell you what, this is an area of the field. It's 4th and 6 at the Alder 38. Wilson's the punter. He was the player that just hauled in that pass on the right side.
They've been working on him as a rugby punt style, too, to give him the defense just a little bit of a look here.
I swear you could have a fake, though, this area of the field. Caudill, the up back, he's a pretty good runner. They'll stamp it to Wilson. He gets it away. Pretty good punt inside the 15. Hits, and it will roll out of bounds on the right side at about the 12. So a punt of 26 yards, no return. Chiefs play field position. 3:08 to go in the half. 7-7 our score. Let's see what Don would have dialed up there. Would you punt or do you go on 4th and 6?
Well, as the radio announcer guy, I would go for it. But as the head coach, I'd punt it.
Okay.
Because, you know, I mean, it's the smart play. Yeah. It's more fun for us if he goes for it.
7-7 our score. Here's a gift to Jewel. Jewel scooting forward and not wanting to go down without some fight. Takes it to the 16, a 4-yard run for Cameron Jewel. 2:55 to go in the first half. Chiefs and Jonathan Alder tied up at 7 on senior night. And Alder not in a hurry either. Jewel, though, kind of limping off the field, Don.
Yeah, that's something to pay attention to.
Scores at peakofohio.com.
There's a lot of eggs in that basket.
Yeah, no doubt. League's leading rusher, Mechanicsburg leading Fairbanks, 14-0. Other scores at peakofohio.com. Here's a broken play. Nussbaum went to hand to his running back, and Nussbaum with some good awareness. The running back did not take the football, but Nussbaum squares forward for a first down. Wow. That looked like it should have been disastrous.
Yeah, he turned, and nobody went to that side. That's a big play there because Bellefontaine could have taken a timeout right there and maybe gotten the ball back with good field position. But now I'm going to guess Jonathan Alder getting the ball to start the second half is going to be content probably to keep running the football.
Yeah.
But no Jewel is a different story.
Here is a give to the backup running back looking to run wide right. Chiefs look like they have it played out and cut it down for a gain of about four on the right side. Other scores, Springfield, Shawnee, and Tecumseh tied up at seven. The backup running back for the Pioneers is Cam Smith, who's a senior. Coldwater and New Bremen tied up at seven.
Ooh, that's a good one.
6-1 at 7-0.
Coach Schmidt gets a win there.
Party tonight.
Yeah, party in New Bremen.
2nd and 5. Nussbaum wants to pass. Has pressure. Brought down. And Nussbaum did a great job to hold on to the football. Chiefs send a corner blitz. It was Kalen Organ who made the sack. Back at around the 20-yard line. And Coach Brown, great awareness from a veteran coach. He takes that timeout. We'll take a timeout. 1:20 to go in the half. The Chiefs and Jonathan Alder tied up at 7. Back with more after this.
High school football season is here. Pedroni's Pizza in Bellefontaine is ready to feed your gang. They offer so much more than just delicious pizzas. If you're looking for something new, try their subs and salads. Pastas, too. They have something for everyone. Pedroni's Pizza in Bellefontaine.
Back here at AccuSports Stadium. Big Lou and Jason are here with the Peak of Ohio TV.com crew video stream. Chiefs just burned their 2nd timeout. They have one remaining. And Coach Brown yelling up at the press box to reset the clock.
I think Coach Brown's yelling at you, Tips.
I'm not the clock operator. That's
I don't know. I saw him. I thought he was yelling, hey, Tipple.
No, it's Mike Vetterino that he was kind of probably yelling to. And we're in the upper tier, as you know, Don. When we come here, we have to climb up into the sky.
Yeah, I don't think Coach Brown. Coach Brown's voice could reach us, maybe.
But, you know, Mr. Vetterino, right on it. He gets it up to 125. So now it's 3rd and 12 after that sack play. Kalen Organ on a corner blitz sacked Nussbaum for a loss of some 7 yards. Nussbaum in shotgun.
Jules back
in the game, and he gets the give. Looking to bounce it out to the left side. Breaks out of some tackles, and he goes forward close to a first down. And the near side official says he went out of bounds at the 31. That stops the clock, and it's not a first down. It's 4th and about 1.5. Well, he shows great balance, though. He is just hard to get. Those great running backs are hard to hit. You know, I think of Coldwater's quarterback in week 2. He was at times a running back, so per se. Just hard to hit.
Jonathan Alder coaching staff thought about it for a second, but that's just way too risky.
Yeah, 4th and 1 at their own 31. They will send in Kaser and the punt team back deep for the Chiefs. Is their punt returner? This time I think it might be Deitch. Can't get a good look at the number. The return man standing at his own 35. And looks like the Chiefs think that maybe
Alder wants to talk about it.
Yeah, they will. We'll take a timeout as well. 1:18 to go in the half. Chiefs and Alder tied up at 7. Back with more after this.
You've got 200 feet of Christmas lights and a big tree out front that's just perfect. You'll be the star of the neighborhood. Just one problem. You got no way to get those things up there.
Now you do. Scott's Equipment Sales and Rental, Bellefontaine, famous for renting cats like Caterpillar and Bobcat Equipment, also rents boom lifts. Get those lights up safe and secure. Just stop by Scott's Equipment on Stockyard Road for a quote or visit our website at scottsequipment.net. This is Sarah from Scott's Equipment, where we rent cats and boom lifts.
Back at AccuSports Stadium, 4th and 1. And Alder, after the timeout, looks like they will punt. Good snap back to the punter. Has pressure. Gets it out of there, though. Hayden Manns was in pursuit. Ball touches at the 42, and then will bound to about the Chieftain 36. That's where Alder will touch it up. So a punt that time of get out the fingers and toes to count this one up. It will be a 33-yard punt. No return. Chiefs have decent field position with one timeout. 1:07 to go on the first half clock. Bellefontaine 7, Jonathan Alder 7.
Hayden Manns almost got a hand on that. He kind of went running past the punter right about the time he kicked it. So no timeouts, but no, they still have one timeout.
Yeah,
that's right.
Because Jewel went out of bounds.
Jewel stepping out of bounds might be huge for him. Keeps the center of the field open for him.
Got our Clark State team members of the week again. Theo Reminder from the Bellefontaine High School Marching Band. He's a junior drum major. And Matt Mott, one of the Chiefs' offensive guards. St. Clair wants to pass. Has time. Looking, throws downfield. It's a deep shot into coverage. Wilson fighting for it, and Wilson cannot make the catch in double coverage right around the Alder 29-yard line.
I give him credit for taking the shot, but I think that I think they should be working more like the 10, 15-yard routes here and try to move it down the field a little bit. I don't know if they quite need to be in desperation mode at this point.
Yeah, it was a deep one down to about the Alder 29. Chiefs second and 10 at their own 36. 7-7 our score, 1 minute to go before halftime.
Jonathan Alder's got some tall corners.
You're right, they do. They like that press coverage at times. This time, St. Clair wants to pass, has pressure, rolls away from it, looks, throws, and it's caught by his receiver who's loose and finally brought down to the far side around the 41-yard line. What a great job by Deitch to work back towards his quarterback. St. Clair saw pressure, rolled left, and threw a strike to Deitch, who's tackled at the Alder 42. In that time of 22 yards, first down Chiefs, game clock is at 45 seconds. Bellefontaine does have a timeout left in this first half, 7-7 our score.
Great job of Fogan picking up the blitz on that last play.
And a procedure on the Chiefs. I'm not sure on who.
Full start.
Calling on one of the offensive linemen, first and now 15 for the Chiefs at the Alder 47. Fountain has one timeout left. Alder has two. 37 seconds left to go in the first half. 7-7 our score here at Bellefontaine High School on senior night. St. Clair in shotgun, wants to pass, has pressure, looks to get away from that pressure. Still on his feet, 45-40, and he'll dance out of bounds at the Alder 37-yard line. Had pressure coming right up in his face, and he rolled away from it. His awareness, his pocket awareness tonight has been good. He's had pressure at times.
Yeah, they're putting Fogan one-on-one on that outside defensive end, and it's a tough block for a running back. But St. Clair with a good decision right there. You know, I think Bellefontaine picks up another 20 yards. He might be entertaining a field goal shot.
Now at the 37, that was a run of 10 yards. Second and five for the Chiefs. St. Clair got out of bounds. St. Clair throws, and it's incomplete.
Oh, a late hit there.
Neer was hit after the play was incomplete. No flag. A little bump that time. Maybe the throw was a little bit behind him.
Yeah, he kind of slid up in the pocket a little bit.
Third and five at the Pioneers 37-yard line. 18 seconds to go before halftime.
Tips, is that the hamburger smell waffling up here, or do you have a different cologne on tonight?
No, it's got to be choice A.
Okay.
I'm not a cologne wearer.
Man.
So that's a long ways away. You got a good nose.
Tips, I've been around a burger or two.
Yeah. Here comes a blitz. St. Clair throws.
Ooh.
And his receiver's hit, incomplete.
Tavian St. Clair's pass.
Now it's fourth and five, and the receiver got hit right in the midsection. That's C.J. Wilson, who is slow to get up.
Yeah, he got hit where you don't have any padding, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, I got you. I call it the midsection, but I know what you're saying. 14 seconds to go in the first half. Fourth and five for the Chiefs at the Alder 37-yard line.
Well, you're going to go here because even if it's a 6-7 second play, you only leave Jonathan Alder with 7 seconds. So.
12 seconds on the play clock. Chiefs were moving, but then the Pioneer defense has gotten a little tougher the last few plays. Play clock down to three. St. Clair wants to pass. Has pressure. Throws towards Reams on the near side. Reams trying to get back to the football. Incomplete.
St. Clair got smashed at the end of the play.
Yeah, he did.
The Bellefontaine offensive line really struggled in this series to keep the defensive line out for Jonathan Alder. St. Clair was elusive on one play and dodged another one by stepping up in the pocket and throwing. But there was a lot of pressure on him this series.
First and 10 for the Pioneers at their own 37. 9 seconds to go in the half. Chiefs will bring in their prevent defense. Defensive backs are some 20 yards back. Chiefs are just three down linemen, and it looks like the Pioneers will get under center and just take a knee.
Well, an entertaining half.
It was.
With only two touchdowns.
7-7 our halftime score. Pioneers scored first after a Chieftain interception where they drove it 56 yards. Chiefs had a 90-yard scoring drive. Chiefs have moved the ball more, but 7-7 our score. And, you know, Dan, what both head coaches will say, Jason Brown for the Chiefs, Nate Stedeker for Jonathan Alder at the half, kind of their thoughts right now, what they'll go over for as they get ready for quarters 3 and 4.
I think the game's playing out like both of them would hope. I think for Stedeker, you know, he's been able to move the ball on the ground with Jewel. They've kept the Bellefontaine big plays somewhat at bay. And I think for the Chiefs, they feel comfortable in the fact that they've, you know, only given up 7 points. I think that they would like the offense to be clicking a little more. And I do think they have to clean up a little bit of the offensive or the defensive pressure that St. Clair has felt that last drive.
Yeah. He took some hard hits. But a physical game. Alder is a physical team. And they've got the league's leading rusher in Cameron Jewel. We're at the half. Get a chance to watch both bands and listen in as well on 107.3 The Drive and peakofohiotv.com. Jonathan Alder with their band here tonight, then the Bellefontaine High School Marching Band. 7-7 our score. Get a chance for our halftime break here. The Chiefs and Jonathan Alder tied up on senior night at Bellefontaine High School. We'll listen to our halftime show and take a look in as well on 107.3 The Drive and peakofohiotv.com.
Collective Culture invites you to experience an array of massage, yoga, and meditation offerings to enhance your wellness journey. Many describe our space as a calm oasis and the perfect spot to reset. If you feel it's important to slow down and give yourself some quiet healing, call or text 937-935-0881 to set up a consultation. Ask about private event opportunities and private classes. Visit collectiveculturewellness.com to schedule your next massage therapy or bodywork session and to register for a yoga class. We look forward to working with you.
I understand. Perfect. Basketball that boy hit 2013. Featuring our majorettes, here's Light 'em Up.
Thank you. Hey, Don's here from Don's Wealth Advisors. Because we take a long-term view of investing, we don't worry about inflation, we plan for it. At Don's Wealth Advisors, we believe that having a plan is the most effective way to invest for the long term. If you don't have a plan or you'd like a second opinion on the plan you have, call us at Don's Wealth Advisors, 592-0200. We've been right here in Bellefontaine for the long term since 1979. No cost, no obligation for that second opinion. Call 592-0200.
Have you been to Fazoli's in Bellefontaine for lunch lately? They have delicious lunch specials every day till 4 p.m. for only $6.99, and that even includes a drink. Here's a couple to choose from. Spaghetti with marinara, fettuccine alfredo, a slice of pizza, and more. Even small house salad. You can even upgrade to premium favorites like chicken fettuccine alfredo or spaghetti with meatballs. Upgrades are only a buck more. Great food, great price at Fazoli's in Bellefontaine.
Are you struggling to keep up? Like many, you may feel your budget has been stretched to its limit. Are you having difficulties due to poor credit? Let Quest Federal Credit Union help you find your financial fitness. Schedule an appointment today to go over budgeting, credit score restoration, and personal finance. Quest Federal Credit Union. Explore the possibilities. NCUA insured, membership eligibility required, equal opportunity lender.
Do you love the beautiful glow your skin gets from the sun? At Buckeye Wash and Tan, you can keep that glow all year round. You don't have to worry about the seasons changing. They have several beds available to help you achieve and keep the look you want. Check out Buckeye Wash and Tan in the Highland Hills Plaza.
Stop by Lee's Famous Recipe Chicken for our 10-piece strips meal at a great price. With 10 of our premium strips, 2 large sides, 5 fluffy biscuits, and 3 sauces, this is dippable chicken done right. Get the 10-piece strips meal at a terrific price, only at Lee's.
Tranquility, we copy you on the ground. You got a bunch of guys about to turn blue. We're breathing again. Thanks a lot.
Hungry after the game? Ready to celebrate the weekend? Ron's Pizza is open late tonight until 11 o'clock. Stop in for a hot, fresh pizza and a nice cold beer. Or call to pick it up at 292-7775. Pull up to the drive-thru window and you don't even have to get out of the car. They have specialty pizzas like buffalo chicken, chicken bacon ranch, taco, BLT, and barbecue chicken. They also offer cauliflower or broccoli and cheddar crusts. Ron's Pizza, South Main, Bell Fountain, 292-7775.
At Bell Fountain's Best Car Wash, we take care of your vehicle 100%, from the first drop of hot, clean water to the last stroke of our super soft, shine-enhancing towel. And ask about Bell Fountain's Best Punch Card. Buy four washes, get the fifth one free. Bell Fountain's Best Car Wash, 720 South Main.
Comer Insurance Agency in DeGraff offers insurance coverage for home, life, auto, commercial, and farm. Visit their website at comerinsuranceagency.com for their number and more information. Comer Insurance Agency, specializing in helping you with the right coverage.
Back at AccuSports Stadium tonight on WPKO HD2 Bell Fountain, 107.3 The Drive, your home of Bell Fountain football, home and away on the radio, and you're getting a chance to watch this game too on our free video stream, peakofohiotv.com. With Don Hensley, I'm Bill Tipple. Thanks to Big Lou and Jason on the video stream. Senior night tonight, 14 Bell Fountain seniors are recognized before the game, along with band and other activities that are part of our fall sports teams in our community. And right now, it's a 7-7 football game. Jonathan Alder scored first on a 29-yard touchdown run by Cameron Jewell. Chiefs counter with a 9-yard touchdown pass from Tavian St. Clair to Chris Fogan. But it's been a slugfest. It's been kind of a defensive game, even though Bell Fountain has much more yards at the half. Teams are loosening up right now. Don's got some of those halftime numbers, and we're going to get those right now. And 7-7 our score. Alder will get the ball to start the third quarter here in a couple of minutes. Don, what are some of the stats that are sticking out to you?
So yeah, I think the 7-7 on the scoreboard, but on the stats sheet, Bell Fountain 245 yards of offense with 109 on the ground, 136 through the air. Jonathan Alder 97 yards all on the ground. So Bell Fountain a little lopsided on the score sheet, but not on the scoreboard.
Yeah, what do you think will be the two or three things that kind of determine the game here on who wins and loses here in the next hour or two?
Well, I think the key to the first half was Bellefontaine turning the ball over that one time. I think turnovers will play a key role, and I think that, Bellefontaine taking some gambles on defense, making sure that they can get Jonathan Alder in some down and distance that aren't favorable. We've seen Jonathan Alder really struggle when they get to a third down and more than 7 yards to go for the first down, so I think that's going to be real key for Bellefontaine.
Halftime score, Bellefontaine 7, Jonathan Alder 7. We'll take a break and come back with the start of the third quarter here in a couple of minutes on 107.3 The Drive and peakofohiotv.com. Back with more after this.
Who's open after the game tonight? Donato's Pizza on South Main Bellefontaine is open until midnight. Order online at donatos.com for pickup or delivery. Donato's Pizza, every piece is important. South Main Bellefontaine and online at donatos.com.
Are you penalized because your bank's head coach is located out of town? At the People Savings Bank, our head coach is right here in your hometown to help you meet your goals. Come score a touchdown with the People Savings Bank. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Nate Dons here from Dons Wealth Advisors. Because we take a long-term view of investing, we don't worry about inflation. We plan for it. At Don's Wealth Advisors, we believe that having a plan is the most effective way to invest for the long term. If you don't have a plan or you'd like a second opinion on the plan you have, call us at Don's Wealth Advisors, 592-0200. We've been right here in Bellefontaine for the long term since 1979. No cost, no obligation for that second opinion. Call 592-0200.
You've got 200 feet of Christmas lights and a big tree out front that's just perfect. You'll be the star of the neighborhood. Just one problem. You got no way to get those things up there.
Now you do. Scott's Equipment Sales and Rental, Bellefontaine, famous for renting cats, like Caterpillar and Bobcat Equipment, also rents boom lifts. Get those lights up safe and secure. Just stop by Scott's Equipment on Stockyard Road for a quote, or visit our website at scottsequipment.net. This is Sarah from Scott's Equipment, where we rent cats and boom lifts.
Back at AccuSports Stadium, getting ready for the third quarter to get underway this quarter. Brought to you by Roof and Benchick Law. Roof and Benchick is in Kenton. They are our quarter sponsor throughout the year of the Chiefs on 107.3 The Drive and peakofohiotv.com. You can see other scores at peakofohio.com. Urbana running away from Benjamin Logan, 37-0. That game is on WPKO. 106.9 The Bull. Graham and North Union were hooked up in a close one. I think it was 20-13. Graham last score. Indian Lake rolling in Northwestern, 35-0. The Lakers are going to break through for their first win. This kickoff brought to you by Dairy Queen of Bellefontaine. Alex Crable tees it up right in the middle of the field at the 40. He'll kick it right to left. Chiefs need to keep digging in defensively. They have not been able to score much. It's a tie game. 7-7 our score as we begin the third quarter tonight on 107.3 The Drive and peakofohiotv.com. Crable puts his right foot into it. It's a lower kick taken by the return man at the 8. Looking to get right upfield, 20-25, runs into a wall of Chiefs and brought down at the 26-yard line. Just a straight return right up the right hash. Pioneers will start at their 26. Return of 18 yards, 11:55 to go in the third, and it's a 7-7 game. Chiefs need to keep digging in defensively, and Don expects to see an aggressive run defense the rest of the way.
Yeah, I think it's really critical. Jonathan Alder has proven that they struggle in third and long situations, and I think Bellefontaine's going to need to take some gambles early in the down and distance to try to create that atmosphere for him.
Jewell is back. He left the game late in the second quarter, but he appears to be okay. Yeah, really, the biggest down to me is first down. Here comes a possible blitz. Chiefs bring it, and Jewell gets through the first wave and bursts out to the 30 for a gain of 4. Chiefs nearly...
See, that's
timed up the snap.
But that's what I'm talking about. They got to take those kind of risks there. And Jewel's slippery, though. He's the full package at running back. He's got the speed. He makes a nice little jump cut there to create a miss and picks up 3 yards.
Second and about 6.5, right at the 30. Have to get to the 36. Here comes Jewel over the left side. Hit. It's a little bit of a push from his line and spins. He always spins. He very rarely does he. One play in the first half where he really got smacked for a loss, but it's hard to get him for no gain or loss. That was for 5, and it's 3rd and 1 coming up for the Pioneers.
Aiden Manns, does he wrestle?
He does not.
He should, because he just took 6'3", 230-pound Aiden Burke and dropped him into a little fireman's carry there and tossed him to the ground.
Third and one. Nussbaum in shotgun. Jewel behind him. Jewel gets the give. Jewel running forwards, got a first down. Still going and brought down around the 44-yard line. 9-yard run, first down Pioneers. 7-7 our score, but Jonathan Alder trying to start this half with a bang, just like they started the first half of the game.
Yeah, he definitely follows his blocks well, too. I mean, he's the complete package at running back. He's got 18 carries for 110 yards, and he's made a couple nice, really nice cuts in the hole, and that was another one right there.
Yeah, you're right. He's got the whole package. He's the best running back the Chiefs have gone against this year. First and 10. Here comes the backup running back. I believe he got about three. That was Jewel, actually. Yeah. A little different formation. He got three, second and seven. Harper Scott with the stop.
Yeah, I think Jewel, if Jewel can walk, he's carrying the ball. I mean,
he is a workhorse.
Being the backup to Jewel is, it's like being a third string NFL quarterback. There's a lot of clipboard carrying.
Yeah, second and seven. Jewel had 373 yards last week against Kenton Ridge. 7-7 our score, 9:45 to go in the third. Nussbaum wants the pass, there's pressure coming. And he throws it into coverage. It's incomplete. Eli Moore with a great job blitzing from his outside backer spot. He made Nussbaum throw it when he didn't want to. Yeah. And it brings up third and seven.
Oof. That's a rough-looking passing game.
Well, it's not just the quarterback, too, Donna.
No.
Because Alder run blocks much better than they pass.
Right.
Block.
They're just not, I mean, of course, Eli Moore gives a lot of people problems. He runs sideline to sideline probably better than any player in the league. But that time, you might want to get a hat on him if you're going to throw the football.
Chiefs at a four-man front. Alder with four receivers. They want a pass. Nussbaum throws to the sidelines, and it's incomplete on the far side around the Chieftain 48, so that'll bring up a punt situation. Fourth and seven. Chiefs on first down held Jewel to three, then back-to-back incompletions gets a Chieftain defensive stop.
Yeah. Again, if they can get the down and distance, get Jonathan Alder behind the chains, it really seems to work in their favor. I mean, if I'm Jonathan Alder, I think third and seven is probably a run play by Jewel.
Yeah.
I'm not too sure. I don't want him running it 40 times a game.
Mm-hmm. He is a workhorse. Kazer, it's a good snap. Chiefs have pressure. Kazer gets it out of there. Hits around the 25, and it will just roll a little bit down to about the 18-yard line. Deitch could not get up to catch it. It was just too shallow of a punt.
I think the official missed. There, yeah, the back judge got it.
Maybe a flag? Of
no, no, no. One of the guys running down touched it barely. And
I touched it earlier, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, so now it will be the Chiefs ball at their own 21. So a difference of 3 yards. 9:25 to go in the third. Well, found seven. Jonathan Alder, seven. Here on senior night at AccuSports Stadium. Chiefs have a long field to drive. Here comes some press coverage on the near side. And Fogan gets the give, not much doing. Lost a yard. Tried to run over left tackle, second and 11 coming up for the Chiefs in the postgame show. We'll have the Don Hensley player of the game.
You know, I thought Bellefontaine blocked really well the first four or five possessions. They struggled to block Jonathan Alder in that last series, and right there, Jonathan Alder, a little bit of a jailbreak up front.
Second and 11, you would think a passing situation. Fogan now will run out into the pattern, and a flag thrown by the side judge.
It's a motion on Bellefontaine.
I'm not seeing what they're doing, though.
At that time I saw it, there was a flinch.
By an offensive lineman?
Yeah, there's some.
False start. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
When Fogan, it's happened twice now when Fogan goes in motion, so I don't know if somebody's hearing him, like, you know, go in motion and they're jumping. I don't know. I mean, that'd be awfully good hearing.
Yeah, we're quite a ways away, but now it's second and 16, and the Chiefs have a long field to deal with here.
It's Bellefontaine's sixth penalty of the game. Jonathan Alder's only been penalized once.
Second and 16 for the Chiefs at their own 15-yard line. St. Clair wants to pass. Throws it out in the right flat, caught by Reams. Reams looking to get up the sidelines. Reverses field, still on his feet. Still going in. Finally, he's still going. Finally cut down at the 47. I thought he stepped out of bounds a couple of times. And that is a huge play. They work out of a second and 16 and get a first down and more all the way up to the 47-yard line. Wow.
Yeah, but it looked like there might have been a late block or something in there.
32-yard gain. What's the call? It's against the Chiefs.
Looked like a personal foul. It was a late block, wasn't it? Yeah.
Away from the play.
Way away.
So one of the offensive linemen called for a blindside block. Well, it's still a first down for the Chiefs, but now we'll be at their own 32 instead of their own 47. They have been hurt by the penalty tonight, and Jason Brown is not. That's something that's a point of emphasis for him.
Well, that's three plays, three 15-yarders that have been after the play's over, which is, you know, Bill, there's one way to clean that up. A lot of running on Saturday.
First down, though, for the Chiefs. It was a 32-yard gain, one of our RV wholesalers' long-distance connections. Now Fogan goes in motion. And it's a double move. They'll throw to Fogan, looks up the ball for the ball, and he makes the catch. What a catch in traffic. Oh, my goodness. He's had two sensational catches tonight. First down at the 39-yard line.
What a great play design right there by Coach Kennedy in the offense. They pump faked the screenplay that they like to run so much and ran Fogan on a wheel route and just put it up for grabs. Fogan has some of the best hands on the team that have been on display the last 2 weeks.
From the 32 to the 39. So a gain of 29 yards. That is another RV wholesaler's long distance connection for your next trip. Go in style with a fifth wheel, travel trailer, or motorhome from RV wholesalers in Lakeview. Shoemaker was in coverage. It was good defense, but just better offense. Here's a toss play to Fogan. 40, 35, still on his feet, and then brought down around the 29. Close to a first down. And Helsley moved the sticks. Gain of 10. Chiefs with some momentum. The big pass play from St. Clair to Reams, and another even bigger one from St. Clair to Fogan has gotten this offense in high gear right now.
Yeah, Fogan's got five catches on the night for about 66 yards, and he's been, ever since last week, he's been an integral part of the passing game.
Mm-hmm. He's a great player.
Just imagine if you're a defensive coordinator and you're trying to figure out how to cover the three wide receivers, now you got to worry about him coming out of the backfield.
Yeah, and he'll go in motion again. Empty look for St. Clair. St. Clair wants to pass out in the flat, caught by his receiver who gets a block, then goes right back into the traffic of the defense and maybe got a yard to the 28. It's one of those wide receiver screens, a long pass from the left hash to the right side, and second and about nine for the Chiefs at the Alder 28. 6:35 to go in the third quarter, 7-7 our score. This possession for the Chiefs started at their 21-yard line.
That time they ran the screen, and C.J. Wilson didn't really have a lot of places to go, so he just cut it up inside there, got the yard, but it just shows the diversity of this passing game. Six guys have already caught passes tonight.
Fogan now in the backfield. He'll go in motion again, another empty look. St. Clair wants to pass, throws, and incomplete right around the 25. His receiver just could not get to the spot. Wilson had a defender right in his way. Now it's third and nine.
That's the second time tonight they've tried to run that little quick screen out there, and the ball has been perilously close to being intercepted.
Mm-hmm.
It's interesting that they keep emptying the backfield with Fogan going in motion.
Yeah.
And that obviously gives St. Clair an idea of, and Coach Kennedy, of who's going to cover him when he comes out. If it's a linebacker, they definitely like that matchup.
Well, now Fogan is a slot to the left. Third and nine. St. Clair wants to pass. Throws, caught by Fogan. Fogan trying to work out of some tackles, brought down at the 25. Gain of three, fourth and six coming up. I would think the Chiefs go for it right here, just with where the ball's at on the field. Fourth and six at the Alder 25, and this is the biggest play of the night here, mid-third quarter, a 7-7 game.
Yeah, I mean, Fogan seems to be the flavor of the drive, but I think here you look for Deitch, who's your possession receiver.
Fourth and six.
Well, where you do that?
Alder offsides, their right end just came across. And Well, they were due for a penalty the last few. I think it's been on the Chiefs.
I don't think it's enough to give him a first down. No. It's going to be about fourth and a half.
But that, you know, very well could change the play call. Here comes Hayden Mans.
Yeah, I like this big fellow leading it up inside there.
Landon Kelly will come out. Well, Kelly's been a very good wing back player this year. Mans comes in for Mans getting more time on the offense. Mans will be wing to the right. St. Clair in shotgun by himself, fourth and one. St. Clair looks for the play. Play clock down to 18. 7-7 our score. 5-10 to go in the third quarter. St. Clair actually wants to pass on fourth and one. Caught by Deitch. Moves forward. He has a first down to the 13-yard line. Boy, how high school football's changed. Fourth and one, and you pass, and you make it look easy, too. 7 yards to Deitch. He is, again, the great route runner. Well, they'll give him six to the 14. So first and 10 at the Alder 14. That is the biggest play of the game so far.
I'll tell you what, short yardage needed. Deitch and St. Clair are about as deadly as it gets. I mean, Deitch's ability to run those routes and his great hands, and St. Clair always seems to be able to put the ball in time. So big first down.
Here's a toss play to Fogan, running to the left. 10, 5. He'll go into the end zone. What a drive by the Bellefontaine Chiefs. 79 yards. They work out of a penalty, a 15-yard penalty. It didn't matter, though. Fogan was sensational on that drive with a big catch, and he capped it off with a 14-yard touchdown run over the left side, and the Chiefs have their first lead of the night. 4:41 to go in the third. Bellefontaine leads Jonathan Alder 13-7 on a 14-yard touchdown run by junior Chris Fogan.
That was really well blocked, too. You know, I know we talked about the offensive line on that last possession, but really good job here on this possession of blocking up front.
Extra point by Crable is up, and it is good. Point after touchdown brought to you by Fissel Floor Covering, and the Bellefontaine Chiefs take their first lead of the night. We'll take a break. 4:41 to go in the third quarter. Bellefontaine 14. Jonathan Alder 7, back with more after this.
Good luck to our Bellefontaine Chieftains football team and cheerleaders this season. We're excited and cheering for you and looking forward to an amazing season. This is Iron City Sports Bar, located at 1125 South Main Street in Bellefontaine, next to Dunkin' Donuts. Please stop by after the game or order ahead after online for convenient carryout online at ironcitysportsbar.com. You can also reach us at 937-404-5288. Home to the best wings, burgers, and steaks in Logan County.
Welcome back to AccuSports Stadium. Kickoff coming up. Thanks to Dairy Queen of Bellefontaine. Alex Crable, the sophomore, tees it up at his own 40. Bellefontaine leads Jonathan Alder 14-7 on 107.3 The Drive and peakofohiotv.com. The Bellefontaine offensive line maybe had some struggles late in the second quarter and right at the beginning of that last possession, but then they really stepped it up. And Crable with a kick that will go down to about the 5, taken by Jewell, the electric running back, looking for a seam hit and cut down at about the 27. Return of 22 yards right up the middle of the field, 4:33 to go in the third. The Chiefs lead Jonathan Alder 14-7. But, you know, the offensive line, they really blocked well on that last possession. The first play, they, I think, were hit for a loss, but after that, their pass protection was excellent. And in the touchdown run, Don pointed it out, a run into the short side, great blocking.
Yeah, Fogan's had, he's up, he's got 110 yards rushing now, and St. Clair's over 200 yards passing. So good balanced drive right there for the Chiefs.
Here comes Jewell running to his left. Jewell cut down by his feet. He was about to pop out of there, it looked like. He got about 5. Second and 5.
He's a scary running back.
Yes. Every time he touches it. Gain of 5.
That one right there was a nice tackle by, it looked like by his ankles there, just about the time he was about to get to the second level.
Eli Moore made the stop. 2nd and 5. Really, first down, I think, is the key down, though. They got 5, so they're in business right now. Here comes Jewell, hit the backfield, trying to get out of there. Chiefs pursuing, and they'll push him down around the 26-yard line. Harper Scott finally just used his speed. That was speed on speed. Jewell got stood up in the hole. That's really what made the play, and it's a loss of 5 yards and 3rd and 10 coming up for the Alder Pioneers.
I'm pretty sure what I saw was Sullivan Ashcraft took the guard into tackle and took him straight back into the backfield. And there was no place for Jewell to go. And when he got outside, Harper Scott was able to use his speed. He's one of the faster defensive players Bellefontaine has. And,
yes.
It's a good matchup there.
Third,
Third and 10, a good down and distance for the Chiefs.
Three receivers to the left, one to the right. Chiefs bring pressure. Here comes a blitz. Nussbaum hit. The ball is loose and is picked up by Bellefontaine at the 14-yard line. And that's not an incomplete pass. That's a fumble recovery for the Chiefs.
It looks like Hayden Mans from the backside. I'd like to see their instant replay, but I did think it was Mans that got to him from the backside and knocked the ball loose.
I thought the initial hit on a blitzer, though, was a corner, actually. I think it was a single number. I don't know, Don.
Once Lou gets that instant replay going, next year. I've been told next year we're going to have instant replay.
All right. What happened so quickly?
Who recovered it? We really miss Brian Lorette up here. Hammond's too much of a cheerleader.
Yeah. First and 10 for the Chiefs. Fogan looking to bounce it out wide. Actually, it's St. Clair who kept a good play fake, and St. Clair ran to his left for about two. Second and 8 for the Chiefs at the Alder 12-yard line, and the Pioneers defense needs to make a stand right here. Chiefs lead Jonathan Alder 14-7, 2:56 to go in the third.
I'll tell you what, nothing good has happened to the Jonathan Alder Pioneers when they have to throw the football.
Mm-mm. Well, the Nussbaum just is under major duress.
That was a couple big plays by the Bellefontaine defense that turned the game around right there.
Second and 8 for the Chiefs at the Jonathan Alder 12, 14-7, Bellefontaine in front. Here comes St. Clair, pass to Fogan. It's actually a lateral. 15, 10, 5, has a lane inside the 5. Touchdown! What a block on the perimeter, right around the 5-yard line. Fogan actually on a lateral. So that will be a touchdown run, even though it looks like a pass play to us. But Fogan takes it 12 yards for the touchdown run over the right side to the far right corner of the end zone. And the Chiefs now lead it by 2 scores, 20-7 over Jonathan Alder with 2:25 to go in the third quarter.
And again, he doesn't even get touched.
Great perimeter blocking. Here comes the extra point by Crable. It is up, and it is no good. Like it was wide right. 2:25 to go in the third. We'll take a break. Chiefs make the turnover pay off on a 12-yard touchdown run by Chris Fogan. Our score with 2:25 to go in the third quarter, Bellefontaine 20. Jonathan Alder 7, back with more after this.
Dairy Queen in Urbana now has the new fall blizzards. Cinnamon roll centers with soft cinnamon roll pieces and brown butter cinnamon topping. Or pumpkin pie. Pumpkin pie pieces blended with vanilla soft serve topped with whipped topping and nutmeg. Hurry, they're only here for a limited time.
Bobcat Multiworks isn't just septic services. They offer portable toilets, promptly delivered, cleaned, and sanitized at competitive rates. From construction sites to weddings to festivals and golf courses, they're the leader in portable toilet solutions. Call today to reserve 585-9904.
Back at AccuSports Stadium, Big Lou and Jason are here with peakofohiotv.com, a chance to watch this game for free with our video stream. You can also, as always, listen on 107.3 The Drive. And the Chiefs on the third quarter for senior night has been pretty memorable. Two touchdowns, and now Bellefontaine leads Alder 20-7. Alder drops the kickoff at the 5. The return man looking to cut loose, and he's finally hemmed in and then brought down by a host of Chiefs right around the 22-yard line. Boy, a very spirited return. The return man just refused to go down that time for Alder. The last touchdown drive for the Chiefs only went 14 yards. Joham Beckel, the return man, gets it to about the 25-yard line. Chiefs did miss the extra point, though. That could, depending how things go here.
I'll tell you what was interesting on that touchdown play is that he threw it behind the, lateraled it to him, so it was a running play. It almost looked like Fogan was, the way it was designed, I thought Fogan was maybe going to look to pass.
Double pass. I thought so initially as well. 20-7 our score. Here comes Jewell. He's hit in the hole. Not much there. Maybe a yard.
I don't think playing catch-up is exactly in Jonathan Alder's wheelhouse.
No. Gain of 1, 2nd and 9. 1:58 to go in the third. The Chiefs lead Jonathan Alder 20-7. There are some very physical football players on this Bellefontaine defense. You think about Ashcraft, Caudill, Moore, Mans. Some guys that when they get the momentum going like this right now, tough sledding for the opposition. 2nd and 9. Chiefs show a possible blitz. Here they come. Nussbaum wants to throw. He airmails out over into the far sideline. Out of bounds around the 40-yard line. Now it's 3rd and 9.
you know, don't forget Declan Shannon, too, because I was shocked when I looked at the stats that he's 18th in the CBC with 51 tackles so far this season.
That's a defensive lineman.
And 11 of them for loss.
Third and nine. Other scores, by the way, at peakofohio.com. Here it's Bell Fountain 20. Jonathan Alder 7, 1:34 to go in the third. Does Coach Bianski dial up another blitz?
I would.
Third and nine. Nussbaum wants to throw back to his left. Wide receiver screen. The receiver makes the catch. He's into the clear. And Carter Snap will make the tackle right around the 46-yard line.
Nice play call.
It was. Rolled right, threw back to the left to hit Isaac Ricker, who is a fast receiver. He was pretty open, though, and a first down gain up to about the 47.
You know, Bell Fountain's been blitzing a lot in that situation, and so they run a little screenplay, and once he breaks that first tackle, there's no line of defense for about 20 yards.
And that's what it was, a 20-yard gain, first and 10 for the Pioneers. Here comes Jewell. Jewell hit, and he'll finally be swung down by about three Chiefs right at midfield. 1:05 to go in the third, Bell Fountain 20. Jonathan Alder 7. We got our Clark State team members of the week. Matt Knott, Bell Fountain senior. A lot of seniors on this team. He's an offensive guard. And Theo Reminder, a junior, who is a drum major at Bell Fountain High. Thanks to Clark State for spotlighting these young folks. Second and 6 for the Pioneers, just inside the 50. 40 seconds to go in the third quarter. Bell Fountain leads Jonathan Alder 20-7. Second and 6. Here's a pass out in the flat. The receiver hit. What a job by the defensive back to work off of the block and dropped him for a loss of about 3 yards. I think it was Caden Snap.
A nice play by Snap to really read that play.
Third and 8 as if for a loss of 2. Well, Caden Snap, just a sophomore, he plays with some giddy-up.
Yes.
He is the young man that had the big hit in the Licking Heights game where the running back went airborne, and I think that Aaron Peitzmeier about did a cartwheel.
I'm looking at some of these linemen for Jonathan Alder, and they got number 53, Andrew Heisler, listed at 225. Say what?
Yeah, Coach Stedeker said he's about 280.
Yeah. I was going to say. I want the Jonathan Alder person that puts their program together to come weigh me.
Yeah, Heiser's the right tackle. He's right in front of us. He's a big man. Biggest man on the field right now, 6'3", about 280. Third and 8. Nussbaum wants to throw. Throws it high. It's incomplete. Tried to throw that comeback route, that misdirection pass again. Incomplete right at midfield. And it brings up 4th and 8 with 18 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. Here comes another punting situation for the Pioneers.
Yeah, the Chieftains are starting to fly around a little bit now after that first quarter where they were, you know, a little bit flat-footed, but now they're running around, you know, and playing spirited defense, like you said. And, you know, Jonathan Alder's just not built to play catch-up football. And
punt returner standing back at his 15. Pumped by Kaiser, goes down to Deitch at the 17, reverses field and will be bumped out of bounds on the near side around the 23-yard line. And then a late flag. A flag right around the Bell Fountain 27-yard line. Chiefs act like it's against the Pioneers. We'll see. 9 seconds to go in the third quarter. And Bell Fountain leads Jonathan Alder 20-7. Blindside block on the Chiefs. And these penalties are away from the play. That's the part that's just such a... You know, there's no way the play, the block was going to help Bell Fountain.
Yeah, I feel like tonight's a night of flashbacks. I just looked down on the field and Coach Clark and Coach Peitzmeier are having a spirited discussion. I felt I was back in the 90s again.
Well, to think about having a guy like Coach Clark still around Bell Fountain football, I mean, he's...
Coach Clark, yeah. Coach Roberts, Coach Lambert, I mean, there's a lot of experience down there.
I've seen... hundreds and hundreds of Bell Fountain football games, maybe even to the thousands when you add them all up. Well, now the Chiefs will start this possession. Yeah, back around the 13, 14. Chiefs will start at their own 14. They'll wind the game clock here, or at least the play clock. Down to 20 seconds, the game clock's still at 9. This third quarter has maybe one play left. St. Clair in shotgun, Fogan off to his left as the Chiefs lead it 20-7. And it's a give to Fogan. Bounces out of a couple of tackles and then brought down at the 15 and a half. Not much, maybe got a yard, yard and a half. That'll be the end of the third quarter. After three quarters of play on the Quest Federal Credit Union High School football scoreboard, they found 20. Jonathan Alder 7 back with the fourth quarter after this.
Who's open after the game tonight? Donato's Pizza on South Main Bellefontaine is open until midnight. Order online at donatos.com for pickup or delivery. Donato's Pizza, every piece is important. South Main Bellefontaine and online at donatos.com.
Hi, it's Liz at Bellefontaine's Comfort Inn. Our Fountain Lounge is Bellefontaine's fun night spot. And right now, we're looking for an experienced bartender who will enjoy working in our fun atmosphere. If you like people, you'll love working at Comfort Inn. Apply in person or call 599-5555.
Bartenders at the Comfort Inn earn more than $9 an hour, and that's plus tips. If you're an experienced mixologist, check out the Fountain Lounge experience. Apply in person at the Comfort Inn where 68 meets 33 or call during business hours at 599-5555.
Stop by Lee's Famous Recipe Chicken for our chicken sandwich combo at a great price. With a premium all-white meat chicken breast and creamy chipotle ranch all on a brioche bun, no other chicken sandwich can compare. Get the chicken sandwich combo at a great price, only at Lee's.
Back at Acme Sports Stadium, we begin the fourth quarter of play tonight on 107.3 The Drive and peakofohiotv.com. Chiefs with a second and 8 at their own 16. Bellefontaine leads Jonathan Alder 20-7. St. Clair, toss play to Fogan, looking to run wide to the right. Still trying to get a seam, 15, 20. Burst forward to about the 21, maybe the 22-yard line. Well blocked on the right wing. Did a good job of sealing it. That's not an easy block to make. And Fogan, the beneficiary of a good job blocking that time. He always runs with great power. He got 6, 3rd and 2. This is a huge play for Jonathan Alder, I think, right here, as they trail the Chiefs 20-7 early in the fourth.
I mean, I think this is maybe the game. You can't let Bellefontaine keep working on the clock, and they need to get, like we talked about, they're not built to catch up in a hurry, so they need the ball back as quickly as possible.
3rd and 2, and we got a flag that's thrown. Another false start on the Chiefs. And that changes things. Instead of 3rd and 2, it's 3rd and 7.
Was that a motion?
Early movement.
Yeah, I mean, that's about the fourth or fifth one of those.
By the receiver that time, the near side receiver, 3rd and 7 for the Chiefs at their own 17-yard line.
No reason for the receiver to move early. He's probably not getting the ball, probably running play.
Now it could be a pass play, though. Play clock down to 5. St. Clair wants to pass. Has plenty of time. Throws. Caught by his receiver, who's hit and brought down right by the marker, right at the 24. Boy, the spot will be critical. Oh, they'll say move the sticks. Deitch is the first down maker. He got pushed back after the catch, but it's always your forward progress. First down at the 24. Wow, that is a huge play.
I don't know if anybody keeps a stat, but I would love to see how many first down catches Colin Deitch has on the season, because it seems like every time he catches the ball, it's for a first down.
He is the first down maker.
And oftentimes it's 3rd and 6 or 7. He just runs his routes right to the sticks.
1st and 10 for the Chiefs at their own 24, leading 20-7. St. Clair gives it to Fogan. Fogan gets to about the linebacker level for about 3 or 4 of a right guard. Called 2nd and 6 at the Chiefs 29-yard line. 10:33 to go. Next week, Don and I will make the trip to Kenton Ridge for another CBC Kenton Trail matchup.
Yeah, we're on the road the next couple weeks, Bill. Sure would be nice to have an RV.
I got the right guy right next to me that can make it happen.
I know.
2nd and 6. Here comes another give to Fogan, looking to bounce it outside, and Fogan brought down around the 29. A sure tackle that time by the Pioneers, only a gain of 1. You would think the Jonathan Alder defense might be getting a little bit of fatigue. They've been out there a bunch this half.
Yeah, what you're seeing right now, too, is St. Clair's taking the play clock all the way down.
Yeah. 20-7 our score. third and six for the Chiefs at their own 29. They have to get to right around the 34. Play clock is down to eight. St. Clair puts Fogut in motion. St. Clair wants to pass. Caught by his receiver, trying to get out of some blocks. Still on his feet, it's Wilson, 40, 45, 50. It's a foot race down the sidelines inside the 40, and he'll be spun down around the Alder 25-yard line. And one of the Alder Pioneers still down on the field. What a block on the wing. I think it was Fogan who threw the key block, and Wilson takes it all the way down to the Pioneers' 25-yard line.
It was a big block by Fogan out there, and Wilson has been cutting it in. That time he kicked it out, a little bit of a different look. And
he did.
About a 47-yard pickup, I think, or somewhere around there.
You were right on it, Don. It is. I just did the math. It is 47 yards all the way down to the Alder 24. One of the Pioneers still down in the field. That's one of our RV wholesalers' long-distance connections. For your next trip, go in style with a fifth wheel or a motorhome from RV Wholesalers. Don wants one on it that says 107.3 The Drive. The Alder Pioneers still tending to the injured player. We'll take a timeout. 9:19 to go in the game. The Chiefs lead Jonathan Alder 20-7. Back with more after this.
As a member-owned financial institution, we stack the deck in your favor. Fewer fees, more frees. Quest Federal Credit Union puts our owners in a position to succeed by offering more opportunities to save where others choose to ding you for every service. Quest Federal Credit Union, member-owned since 1969. Bank better. Quest Federal Credit Union, explore the possibilities. NCUA insured, membership eligibility required, equal opportunity lender.
Back at AccuSports Stadium, Chiefs showing their balance, their depth, and their speed. A 47-yard short pass play to Wilson, about a 5 or 6 yard pass. It was going to be a little bit short of the first down. Got a key block from Fogan. Boy, Fogan can really block, too. I mean, he can do it all.
Yeah, he's done it all tonight.
And he took it all the way down to the 24 of Alder. The Chiefs up 20-7. 9:03 to go in the football game here at AccuSports Stadium on senior night. St. Clair in shotgun. Fogan off to his left. Fogan, actually, St. Clair keeps it. Looking to get to the sideline and cut down inbounds at the Pioneers' 22-yard line. Not much, maybe got a couple of yards.
Good job of staying in bounds right there. That's the most critical part.
Mm-hmm.
You know, unofficially, of course, I've got St. Clair 20 of 31 for about 262 in that neighborhood right now. Another big night for him throwing the football.
Yeah.
He's not going to like that interception, though, on his record, but it's only the third one of the year.
Second and eight for the Chiefs at the Jonathan Alder 22. And
ooh,
it's a pop pass to Manns, who came in motion. And he'll actually lose a couple of yards. And there was all kinds of action in the backfield. Don thought it was going to be a pop pass to Fogan, I believe.
Well, I was a little worried it might be intercepted by a defensive lineman
there. There was some traffic. Loss of three, third and 11. They're trying to get them with that misdirection, but Alder has been Johnny on the spot with that.
Well, it's four down territory here. I like that swing pass to Fogan out of the backfield. It's been effective.
Oh, maybe an offsides by the Pioneers?
No call.
Jason Brown's letting the official know about it.
He's like, how did four guys jump off across the line? Nobody got called.
Third and 11. Play clock down to five. St. Clair wants to pass. That's time. Throws towards the end zone, and it's picked off. Picked off right around the 10-yard line. Alder's still alive, and the return man will be knocked out at the 26-yard line. Picked off by Fennec right around the Alder 10. Well, that gives them hope. And then a flag thrown afterwards.
Let's talk about the interception first. I think that St. Clair never saw the Fennec kind of rub off of his guy and play a little bit of that robber position and step right in underneath the throw. Unsportsmanlike on Jonathan Alder.
Well, that's a new tune right there. That's the first dead ball on the Pioneers like that. They make the interception return from the 10 to the 27. Well, it was the interceptor. Fennec, he made the pick and then must have said something well after the play. He was out of bounds for 2 or 3 seconds, then the flag was thrown. That will move the ball back to around the 13 or 14.
You know, why I think that he never saw Fennec was if he'd have seen him, he'd have thrown that ball with a little bit more air towards the corner.
Yes.
Instead, he kind of threw it short like he never saw him sitting there.
Yes. Yeah, near, I think, was the intended receiver. Now Alder has it at their own 13, 7:27 to go. Nussbaum looking to keep it. Nussbaum hit, kind of somersaults up to about the 17, got 4 yards. 7:15 to go in the game. The Chiefs lead Jonathan Alder 20-7 here on 107.3 The Drive and peakofohiotv.com. This fourth quarter presented by Roof and Benchick Law. Roof and Benchick is in Kenton. All the scores, by the way, at peakofohio.com tonight.
Nussbaum's a nice, you know, nice running runner, but I think Bellefontaine's perfectly happy letting him run the ball and not Joel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now it's an empty set. Nussbaum by himself. They'll send Joel in motion. It's a pop pass to Joel. Joel looking to get free, and he's brought down by a host of Chiefs around the 25, but it's a first down. 6:43 to go in the game. The Chiefs lead it 20-7. And really, and Jonathan Alder could be in four down territory right now.
Yeah, well, yeah, with 6 minutes left, they've got to keep the football.
Actually, they'll say Joel got to the 26 on that pass play.
Well, Graham, 26-20 over North Union.
Yeah, that would be a shocker.
Coldwater, 27-14 over New Bremen.
Okay. Cavs will go to 8-0 if they maintain that lead. Nussbaum throws the ball, deflected. Deflected by Eli Moore, incomplete. Almost intercepted by one of his fellow defensive teammates. And looked like Shannon almost scooped it up after it was deflected right at the line of scrimmage. Incomplete, second and 10, 6:15 to go in the game. And the Chiefs lead it 20-7.
Eli Moore has been noticeable tonight, especially in the passing game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Looks like Bellefontaine's moved now to a 3-4 look. Ashcraft looks to be standing up now.
And what do we have? Maybe a timeout? Timeout, Jonathan Alder. We'll take a break with these Pioneers. 6:15 to go in the football game, and our score on the Quest Federal Credit Union High School Football Scoreboard, Bellefontaine 20, Jonathan Alder 7. Back with more after this.
High school football season is here. Pedroni's Pizza in Bellefontaine is ready to feed your gang. They offer so much more than just delicious pizzas. If you're looking for something new, try their subs and salads. Pastas, too. They have something for everyone. Pedroni's Pizza in Bellefontaine. Do you love the beautiful glow your skin gets from the sun? At Buckeye Wash and Tan, you can keep that glow all year round. You don't have to worry about the seasons changing. They have several beds available to help you achieve and keep the look you want. Check out Buckeye Wash and Tan in the Highland Hills Plaza.
Back at AccuSports Stadium, Jonathan Alder burns their first time out. They have two remaining. The Chiefs have all three remaining. And Bellefontaine leads Jonathan Alder 20-7 with 6:15 to go in the football game. Pioneers, though, with their second interception of the night. Still hanging on here. Second and 10 at their own 26. And the running back hit in the backfield. It's the backup running back, and he's brought down. What defense?
That's Hayden Manns, I'm pretty sure. I can tell just because of the orange shoes, but he just beat his man off the ball.
Yeah, he is a handful to block. Third and 12, loss of 2. It's another Dairy Queen Blizzard Blitz sack of the night. You're listening to high school football on WPKO HD2 Bellefontaine, 107.3 The Drive, and getting a chance to watch it on our free video stream at peakofohiotv.com. Third and 12 for Jonathan Alder at their own 24. Nussbaum wants to pass, has pressure, now looks to reverse field, trying to get to the sideline. 25, looks to scoot upfield and scoots out of bounds at the 29-yard line, but that will make it 4th and 8. And with 5:31 to go in the game, Alder down by 2 touchdowns, I think they got to go.
Yeah, they've got to go for it here. Nice job by Bellefontaine of pulling off there and not hitting him out of bounds. Two guys had a shot there at the very end.
Yeah, he was under some real pressure, got about 5 yards on the run. 4th and 7 for the Pioneers. Nussbaum runs over to his bench for the play call. Play clock down to 15.
I just got a funny feeling that Peitzmeier and Viansky send the house right here.
Do you really? Okay. Three-man front. Play clock down to 3 seconds. 2 seconds, and they get it off. Only 3 rushers. Nussbaum wants the pass, throws into coverage, and it's caught by his receiver. Did he lose the football right at the end? Bellefontaine thinks they've got the football.
Blown it down.
Oh, boy. Close. First down, Pioneers up to the 39. Gain of 10.
Yeah, the reason I said that on the blitz is I would rather see them send some pressure. Nussbaum doesn't look like a quarterback that likes to feel any pressure. And rushing three and sitting in the zone allowed him to sit there and survey the field.
Yeah. Here comes Jewell running around the left side. Jewell still on his feet, and he scoots forward for about 10 to the 49. And now Jonathan Alder into a little bit of a rhythm. 5:05 to go in the game. This game's not over. One of the Chiefs' defensive linemen, Zane Bailey, has to come off the field. Keegan Overton-Story, another senior, comes in for him. First and 10 for the Pioneers at their own 49. Game clock winds down to 4:55 to go. Chiefs up 20-7. Here comes a possible blitz. Eli Moore chasing Nussbaum down from behind. Got him, but Nussbaum ran over right guard for about 5 yards. Second and 5 for the Pioneers.
Right now for Bellefontaine, I think they're okay with 3 or 4 yards of carry as long as the clock keeps moving.
Mm-hmm.
4:36 left, still two possession game. And Jonathan Alder still taking a lot of time in the huddle.
Yeah, second and 5.
I mean, they've got like 6 running plays. Just be turn around, give it to Jewell.
Jewell is in the backfield, it appears, right next to Nussbaum. Nussbaum rolls right. Now wants to throw back that side. It's caught by Jewell, who's got a couple of blockers. Looks to get outside and will be swung down right around the 40-yard line.
That is a great play by number 5.
Kalen Organ.
Great play. He was getting blocked. That was wide open.
Mm-hmm. I think it's still a first down, but it could have gone for much more. 5-yard gain to the Bellefontaine 41. First down on the throwback pass. Roll left, throw back to the right. They say, actually, he got tackled. I thought he got swung out of bounds. So the game clock keeps going. Under 4 minutes to go in the game. And now, I wonder if the Jonathan Alder coaches didn't say something about that. Right now, 3:59, we got the Clark State Team Members of the Week. Bellefontaine offensive lineman Matt Mott, a senior, and Bellefontaine band member Theo Reminder, who is a drum major. Theo is a junior. They will maybe add some time here. 20-7, the Chiefs lead. Jonathan Alder, it's not over yet. See if they put any more time up there.
409.
4:09 to go. Yeah, I thought Jewell got swung down out of bounds on the far side. Nussbaum in shotgun. He'll give it to Jewell. Jewell looking to run to his left. Hit by, a host of Chiefs. They've had really crisp gang tackling in this game. I know Jewell got loose for a 29-yard touchdown in the first quarter, but it's been really good team defense. Only a gain of 2, second and 8.
Yeah, it really starts with the penetration the guys up front are getting.
Right now it's 3 down guys. Chiefs send a blitz. Nussbaum wants to pass. Throws downfield into coverage, and it's broken up at the last minute by Caden Snap. Wow. Beckel had a chance to catch it around the 3. Incomplete.
I was impressed that Snap didn't get called for pass interference either. A little hand fighting down there, but went both ways.
A flag in the backfield, though. Wow, that's an area you usually see like roughing the passer or something like that, but it's an offensive 15-yard penalty, and that, I think, could be a drive killer.
Yeah, if you don't throw the ball well, you don't want to be in too many third and 15s.
This is...
4 second and 15, or third and 15.
Yeah, it should be a loss of the down, wouldn't it?
Yes.
So it was incomplete.
I would think. Now they're saying second down. The referee's got the 2 up there. So second down and
a bunch.
Country mile.
Second and 23. Alder has it at their own 46. They need to get to the Chieftain 31. Nussbaum wants to pass. Has pressure. Looks to get away from that pressure. Hit in the backfield and brought down. Got back to the line of scrimmage. Maybe got half a yard. But he is under major duress. Sullivan Ashcraft. Chiefs will look to substitute. Landon Kelly is in.
A little better job getting off the field this time.
Keegan over to Story. Nussbaum wants to pass. Has plenty of time. It's a 4-man rush. Throws into coverage. Deitch there. And Deitch maybe got in the way of the receiver. It still got over Deitch's hands. Incomplete at the Chieftain 15-yard line, and now brings up 4th and 23.
Well, two Jonathan Alder receivers ran into each other about 15 yards down the field and wiped out two out of the pass route there.
3:07 to go in the football game. Chiefs lead it 20-7. This could be your ball game on this next play. 4th and 22 at the Alder 47-yard line.
I think it's a long 22, Bill.
22 and three quarters.
22 and some change.
Play clock is down to 2 seconds. But the officials are huddling. Now they're going to reset things here. Now on this play, 4th and 22, 3:07 to go in the game. Chiefs up 20-7 to you. Do you bring pressure on this play, Don?
No, I think on 4th and 22, I'm going to sit back in some kind of soft shell and let them catch it underneath and try to rally and make the tackle.
Okay, I wouldn't be surprised maybe if they bring three down guys, but maybe would you bring a backer? It doesn't look like it.
I wouldn't, but...
They will. Here comes a backer. Nussbaum looking to pass, now looking to step up. Oh, he is hit hard! Wow, is he brought down. What a hit in the backfield. Loss of three.
I think it was
Alex Cardill. That may have been the hit of the night. Wow.
58.
What a hit on Nussbaum. He's able to get up off the ground and walk off the field, but he absolutely got tattooed. The Chiefs take over on downs at the Alder 44-yard line. And this baby's just about over. 2:59 to go in the game, and the Chiefs lead it 20-7.
If Alex Caudill is not the defensive player of the year in the CBC, I want to see who is. Because he's been the best defensive player on the field every week.
Can't argue with that. Hayden Manns was something special tonight, too. 1st and 10 for the Chiefs at the Alder 43. It's Fogan over the right side. Fogan into the secondary. Fogan still going hard and finally brought down around the 33-yard line.
Number 4, Chris Fogan, running hard for
first the down for the Chiefs to the 33, gain of 10. The officials say move those chains.
Big win tonight if the Chiefs can hold on here, Bill. This probably jumps them up at least probably to number 3, I would say, in their region.
Alder in that same region.
They were 12th coming in.
Mm-hmm. Chiefs were 4th this week. Chiefs about to go to 7-1 and beat Alder for the first time since the 2018 season.
Just get in the top 4, baby, because I am never going back to Western Brown.
Even with an RV.
Even with an RV.
1st and 10. Fogan looking to run around the right side, then cuts it up inside and lost a couple of yards to the 35. Alder has 2 timeouts remaining. Game clock continues to tick down to 2:12. See if Coach Snedeker wants to use a timeout. Not yet.
Yeah, I think he stopped it. That's his last. He's got one left.
2:04 to go in the game. We'll take a break. The Chiefs lead Jonathan Alder 20-7 here on Senior Night at AccuSports Stadium. Back with more after this.
Football Friday night means you can get a 16-inch two-topping pizza for only $16 at Firehouse Pizza in Zanesfield. Add some breadsticks or wings. See why Firehouse Pizza was voted best pizza in Logan County. Visit our Facebook page at facebook.com/firehousepizzaandsubs.
Back at AccuSports Stadium, Jonathan Alder burns their 2nd timeout. They have 1 remaining, 2:20 to go in the football game as they reset the game clock. Chiefs are going to win kind of a defensive game tonight. The Chieftain defense was up to the task. Cameron Jewell's the best running back the Chiefs have faced this year. I don't know if he's the best in the CBC. Chris Fogan might debate that. Seeing the two best right here. I mean,
yeah.
Fogan and Jewell are both outstanding football players. Fogan had a big night. Chieftain defense stepped in too. And the way they run to the ball and hit, wow.
I'm not sure you can really say, though, it's been defensive struggle because Bellefontaine's racked up over 400 yards of offense.
A couple turnovers.
Yep.
2nd and 12 for the Chiefs at the Alder 35. Here comes Fogan again. Barrels into the defense, takes it to the 32.
Chris Fogan, the ball carrier.
Game clock. Well, did Coach Snedeker use his final timeout? He did. We'll take a break as well. 2:14 to go in the game. Bellefontaine leads Jonathan Alder 20-7. Back with the final 2:14 after this.
Have you been to Fazoli's in Bellefontaine for lunch lately? They have delicious lunch specials every day till 4 p.m. for only $6.99, and that even includes a drink. Here's a couple to choose from. Spaghetti with marinara, fettuccine alfredo, a slice of pizza, and more. Even small house salad. You can even upgrade to premium favorites like chicken fettuccine alfredo or spaghetti with meatballs. Upgrades are only a buck more. Great food, great price at Fazoli's in Bellefontaine.
Welcome back to AccuSports Stadium. You can see up-to-date scores at peakofohio.com. Here, Bellefontaine leads Jonathan Alder 20-7, 2:14 to go in the game. Alder is out of timeouts. Third and nine for the Chiefs at the Alder 32. And one more first down will make this a formality.
If I'm Bellefontaine, though, you got to run the football here.
I agree with you. Wing to the right is Manns. It'll be Fogan who gets a good give, a little bit of a push there from Manns on the left side, but only got about 2 yards. Caleb Miller, top linebacker for Alder, made the stop. Two-yard gain, fourth and seven.
If I'm Coach Brown, I'm going to bleed it all the way down and take a timeout here.
Yep. He's already on that, I think. Chiefs tonight did move the ball up and down the field. Not their sharpest game, I guess, when you look at execution, but the way they flew around and how hard they played really stood out. Well, it looks like they're going to maybe run the play. Game clock's down to three. It'll be Fogan looking to run to the left. Gets a little bit of a block. He's into the secondary. 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown!
Or just do that.
Wow, what a run by Fogan. He is fresh. The older defense was not, and that fourth down play goes 30 yards for a touchdown. Fogan with his fourth touchdown of the game tonight. Three of them rushing. One of them was a catch on fourth down earlier in the game, and the Chiefs now lead it 26-7 with 1:19 to go in the football game.
Yeah, he's got 175 yards rushing and three touchdowns. He's also got 69 through the air, so.
Extra point by Crable is good. We'll keep it right here. Point after touchdown brought to you by Fissile Floor Covering. The Chiefs now lead it 27-7. And Chris Fogan tonight had just an outstanding football game. He did running. He's got three touchdown runs. Now, one of them was a pass play, but it was a lateral, so technically it's a rush. So three touchdown runs. Had a touchdown catch on fourth down on a great pass play. Great pass and catch from St. Clair to Fogan in the first half, which got the Chiefs on the board. That was in the second quarter. He also had a big block that sprung Wilson for a 47-yard play.
Yeah, he's had a couple of blocks on the screen plays. He's done it all tonight. St. Clair with the 7 touchdowns last week. Fogan says, all right, I'll give you 4 this week, and let's keep this little competition going.
Yeah, well, it's good to have that when you got great players and still have chemistry on your team. This is the makings of what could be really a special run the final few weeks here.
Yeah. Fogan now has 12 touchdowns on the season. St. Clair, 19 throwing touchdowns. If I'm Jake Kennedy, I'm liking what I see.
Chiefs squib the kickoff, taken by one of the upbacks, the 28. That return man is then brought down around the 34. 1:13 to go in the game. Chiefs lead at 27-7. And this game at the halftime was a 7-7 game.
Yeah, but I think Bellefontaine, when they got up, once Bellefontaine got up, that's just not Jonathan Alder's game. And,
no.
To me, the big play of the game was the strip sack on the down, put Bellefontaine on the 14-yard line, and they went in and gave themselves a 2-touchdown lead.
Yep. First and 10 for Alder at their own 35. Nussbaum rolls right, looking to step up, throws a little bit high on the far side out of bounds around the 45. 1:07 left to go in the game. Chiefs lead it 27-7. Bellefontaine will move to 7-1. Alder will fall to 5-3 next week. The Chiefs are at Kenton Ridge. Alder will host Tecumseh next week.
Yeah, Tecumseh, we haven't seen a score yet, but it was 14-14.
With the Arrows and the Shawnee Braves, yeah. Yeah, all these scores at peakofohio.com. And I thought that'd be a good game tonight. I would have probably picked Shawnee, but I thought it'd be a good game. Here comes the running back who's swung down harshly. Jewell, who then just kind of tosses the football in disgust. It was Ashcraft again. Loss of about, loss of, well, let's say one. Third and 11. Game clock at 45 seconds. Chiefs lead it 27-7. Alder with a third and 11 at their own 34 here late in the fourth quarter. All right, Bellefontaine's defensive front has been really good tonight. And their linebackers. Here comes the backup running back. Cam Smith looking to run wide to the right. Hit and brought down inbounds. Good tackle on the edge.
Flags everywhere.
There's a flag by the back judge.
It's a post-play foul, too. I'm not sure who they're going to get, but they can probably take their choice.
Wow. Game clock stopped at 22 seconds. Bellefontaine leads Jonathan Alder 27-7. Parker Knox will come in. One of the Chiefs will go out. I think that's Sullivan Ashcraft. And senior night, he gets a big a big round of applause from the fans and his teammates. He is a...
He's played the whole year with a torn ACL. I don't think I've ever seen that in football.
I've not either. So the foul was... Was it some kind of a block, or was that?
It was a late hit, well after the ball was dead. Yeah, I don't think people really can appreciate what Sullivan Ashcraft's done this year. Playing with a torn ACL, and really, you look at his stats, his output has still been consistent. And, yeah. And he's changed, you know, he's dropped down, giving him a better look at defensive end. What a season for that senior.
Now the game clock down to 12. Alder might not just run another play. They don't have to. It's 4th and 25. This might be it. They're in shotgun.
That's
game clock is down to 3, 2, 1. That's it. And the Chiefs, a big winner on senior night.
Nothing's better than winning on senior night.
Bellefontaine outscores Jonathan Alder in that second half 20-0, and Bellefontaine, more importantly, wins their senior night contest here at AccuSports Stadium. The final score, Bellefontaine 27, Jonathan Alder 7. A dominant second half. Their run defense was up to the task against the league leader, Cameron Jewell. Bellefontaine made enough plays offensively, and Chris Fogan had a phenomenal football game tonight. Fogan and the defense certainly carried the day, and the Chiefs win it 27-7. Don and I will come back and wrap it up right after this on 107.3 The Drive and peakofohiotv.com.
Collective Culture invites you to experience an array of massage, yoga, and meditation offerings to enhance your wellness journey. Many describe our space as a calm oasis and the perfect spot to reset. If you feel it's important to slow down and give yourself some quiet healing, call or text 937-935-0881 to set up a consultation. Ask about private event opportunities and private classes. Visit collectiveculturewellness.com to schedule your next massage therapy or bodywork session and to register for a yoga class. We look forward to working with you.
Chiefs a winner tonight on senior night as they beat Jonathan Alder 27-7. Other scores at peakofohio.com. Tecumseh leading Springfield Shawnee 21-17 in the fourth quarter. Northeastern leading at West Liberty Salem 19-10 in the fourth quarter. Versailles leading at St. Henry 19-9. You can see all these scores up to date at peakofohio.com. Graham still upsetting North Union 32-27 in the fourth quarter. So all these scores again at peakofohio.com. And in the fourth quarter, one that interests Don, Chris Schmitty-Schmidt, New Bremen losing at Coldwater. Close, though, fourth quarter, 35-28. But here are the Chiefs on senior night. Big win. Jonathan Alder has been a tough task the last few years. Not only beating the Chiefs, but winning by wide margins. Last year was 42-7, Jonathan Alder. 2 years ago during the COVID season, Jonathan Alder won 38-8. That was a team that made it to the regional finals. It was an exceptional football team. But tonight, the Bellefontaine Chiefs turned the table. They were physical. Their run defense was really, really strong. And then, you know, Chris Fogan just, he would not be denied. 3 rushing scores. He also caught a touchdown. Chiefs moved the ball. Now, they weren't so great in the red zone. I know Coach Brown is always talking about complimentary football. How can we get better? That's what he says about his team. How can we get better? What can we do better? And that, to me, means I say that every week. He knows he's got a good team because he's going to push them. 27-7, the Chiefs win it. They go to 7-1, 3-0. Alder drops to 5-3, 1-2 in the CBC. Don's got some numbers. But before the stats, just what you saw in the game tonight, what were a couple of your big takeaways?
Well, I think the defense, you know, kind of won the game for them with that strip sack in the third quarter and allowed Bellefontaine to go by two touchdowns. And once they got up two touchdowns, Jonathan Alder's just not built to catch up. Bellefontaine was more physical, I thought, on both sides of the ball. But, you know, it's going to be a game, you know. I think about, like, what you saw tonight, and you saw how tough the Bellefontaine defense can be. Everybody knew Jewel was going to get the ball. He carried the ball 25 times. But he got a somewhat pedestrian 123 yards. They did a good job of kind of not really letting him get loose. I think his biggest gain of the night, he had the 29-yard touchdown. But after that, he only had one gain of 10 yards or more on the next 23 carries. So, you know, I think the Bellefontaine defense did a really nice job of bottling him up. They were more physical, and I think they wore him down by the second half. I think we really saw the physical nature of the Chieftain defensive line kind of take over that offensive line of Jonathan Alder.
Well, one of the hard parts about two things make defense, I think, hard to play. That's when you have to be out there for a long time. But the other thing is when you don't know what the other team's going to do, when you have that uncertainty. That wasn't the case for Bellefontaine. They knew what Alder wanted to do. They practiced it throughout the week. And when you know what the other team's going to do and you have a good team yourself, it's tough to move the ball against that defense.
Yeah, and, you know, I think Bellefontaine, that first drive, they wanted to see how they could play Jonathan Alder against their base. After that, you know, they scored, you know, 2.5 minutes into the game. And then they kept them off the scoreboard the rest of the way, and they were much more aggressive defensively. Alex Caudell and Ashcraft and Eli Moore and Hayden Manns really made their presence felt with some really big hits that starts to wear down a running back a little bit. But, you know, we're talking about the offense and, you know, how did the offense do? Well, they still almost rolled up 500 yards. They had 458 yards on the night. St. Clair was 21 of 32 with 260. He had the touchdown pass, but he had the two interceptions. Fogan was 23 carries for 175 yards. He also had six catches for 69 yards. So 458 yards of offense, that's still, you know, most coaches would you know,
love that.
Be glad to have 458 yards of total offense. Now, you know, Bellefontaine goes to Kenton Ridge, always a rival. Kenton Ridge has had a tough season this year.
Yeah.
You know, there's a big one looming in Week 10 with a trip to London, which has also been a tough place for the Chiefs to play, and a lot could be on the line there.
Yeah, Bellefontaine, you know, you see them every week, you study it, you have a real passion for football and for Bellefontaine football. To me, and Coach Brown says this a lot, Coach Peismeyer used to say this back in the day, you either get better or you get worse. Bellefontaine's getting better.
Yeah, and I think the big thing is they're getting better on the defensive side of the ball, which is what wins you championships. And, you know, there's you know, this was a tough matchup tonight. I thought Alder wanted to try to control the clock. And you know, Bellefontaine, once they got him behind the chains a little bit, you know, third and long, Jonathan Alder really didn't have any answers. I mean, they did throw the ball kind of uncharacteristically for them 15 times tonight, but they only completed five of them, and that was only for 41 yards. So they were 5 of 15 for 41 yards. Bellefontaine really just took that away. And when they did, there was two or three times that they passed that Bellefontaine had big sacks. So
next week at Kent Ridge, the Don Hensley player of the game.
Well, if I was going to go offense and defense.
Yeah, you can do that. Your award, you can do what you want.
I would say that on defense I'd have Manns and Caudell kind of share it because I thought both of them were very impactful. Alex Caudell is, talk about a guy that's just improving every week. And he is. I do think he is the best defensive player I've seen this year in the CBC. And Hayden Manns, you know, he just eats up so much space on that defensive line. He's so quick, he's hard to block. But the player of the game has to be Chris Fogan. 23 carries, 175 yards, 69 more. And Fogan's ability to insert himself into the passing game has made Bellefontaine even more deadly on offense the last couple weeks. And I think he's the, you know, that ability of him to catch the football out of the backfield is a big reason why over the last 2 weeks, Bellefontaine's run up over 1,000 yards of offense.
Yeah, Chiefs with the win go to 7-1, 3-0 in league play. Jonathan Alder falls to 5-3. They're now 1-2 in the CBC. Pioneers will host Tecumseh next week. The Chiefs head to Kenton Ridge. We'll have that game on 107.3 The Drive and streamed at peakofohio.com for you to listen to. Our next peakofohiotv.com game for the Chiefs will be Week 10. Big Lou is making the trip to London. Maybe he'll have that RV ready, Don.
So we're going on the road with Lou and his posse.
Yeah, we are.
That's all right. Well, the more road games Lou gets in, the more chance we've got for that RV.
He's all about the Chiefs winning, though, over the next couple weeks, because week 11, he wants to be right here.
I want to be right here for week 11 and week 12. And so let's get him in the top four here.
Yeah.
But I think Bellefontaine's a tough ask for anybody on this schedule, including London in week 10, because as we continue to talk, I mean, six guys got a touch tonight in the passing game. There's just too many weapons for most high schools to cover.
Yeah, and Bellefontaine's offensive line, you know, we talked about going into half, had kind of a rough series, but then they really cleaned it up. I thought, you know, give them great kudos, too. Chiefs win it 27-7 as they dominate the second half tonight against visiting Jonathan Alder. Thanks to Ty Avila and Xander Kuhn back at Studio Control. We thank all of our sponsors, and we thank you for listening and watching on 107.3 The Drive and peakofohiotv.com. You can see up-to-date scores, by the way, at peakofohio.com. Final score one final time tonight here at AccuSports Stadium on senior night. The 14 seniors go out with a win. Bellefontaine 27, Jonathan Alder 7 for Don Hensley. I'm Bill Tipple saying have a good weekend.